Talk of the town with the restless gal. Don't you bother to fool him around. Keeps the vomits on the run, boy. Keeps the vomits on the run. You may think he's a sleepy type guy, always takes his time. Soon I know you'll be changing your mind when you've seen him use a gun, boy. When you've seen him use a gun, he's the top of the West. Always cool, he's the best. He keeps alive with his car 45. Seen him use a gun, boy. When you've seen him use a gun, he's the top of the West. Always cool, he's the best. He keeps alive with this Colt 45. Who's the guy? He's riding to town in the prairie sun. You won't bother to fool him around when you've seen him use a gun, boy. When you've seen him use his gun.
Keep your hand on your gun. Don't you trust anyone. There's just one kind of man that you can trust. That's a dead man or a gringo like me. Be the first one to fire. Every man is a liar. There's just one kind of man who tells the truth. That's a dead man or a gringo like me. Don't be a fool for a smile or a kiss, or your bullet might miss. Keep your eye on your goal. There's just one rule that can save you your life. It's a hand on your knife and the devil in your soul.
keep your hand on your gun. Don't you trust anyone. There's just one kind of man that you can trust. That's a dead man or a gringo like me. Keep your hand on your gun. Don't you trust anyone. There's just one kind of man that you can trust. That's a dead man or a gringo like me. Or a gringo like me. Or a gringo like me. Like me.
People who use this word as an insult don't seem to have a clue about what it means. Today, it's used as a term to describe a man or woman who enjoys watching their significant other having sex with another person. For some reason, it's inherently shameful.
I think it's time to sue a stereos. Coke and nose, don't you know that coke and nose is not the way to go to float your message coast to coast to find a way to boast a host? Not even once that dick fucked. You dug yourself into a ditch and now your shit stuck. You even had the advantage. You ran the best fucking page on the planet. They damaged you, Maddox, and made you so mad that you managed to mangle the matter in court. You couldn't take matters into your own hands like a man, thought your fan base would offer support. Nope, only Landau. But don't bite the dog that feeds. It's agreed that you have failed to see how you became a mockery of what you used to be. Now Dick is your master son. And I know that might suck, but it don't suck as much as your ex while she's giving Dick head and you're watching him busting a nut. Cuck. That's all. The biggest problem isn't up for debate. Your persona is a recipe that's gone out of taste, so just bow down and give in to fate. That's my fucking fake persona. Have the S's making moves to creep upon you. Lock your doors and don't just scream or holler. Have the S's taking every dollar. Wait until you hit the wall for 20 million that you'll never get to see. You were once a man who had some fans who loved you, now you'll never get to be.
Little bitch.
Cook!
Run by a gorilla that can rap fast. Another who can draw and then like 15 fucking lab rats. Brock is getting fucked like he's become a fucking pack rat. Leaf is in the club now and so Brock just wants to tap that. Briefly taken down by some pathetic foreign sad sack who tried to take the viewers cause he's never fucking had that. This filthy little Rusky better gear up in his hazmat. If I were you I'd cover up your ass crack. And if you're not a massive bitch then I'm a fucking pacifist. So tell me who you are and then I'll show you just what drastic is. I'll turn you to a masochist then burn you with the mattresses they throw out at the dump after some accidents from bastard kids.
That's an invitation.
Ooga fucking ooga cunts. All rise for the very, very honorable Justice Schmeckel. Today we are overseeing the case of Scooby versus AP, or I should say AP versus Scooby. We have not yet seen the defendant. We don't know if he's going to arrive in the courtroom today. He has been sent a summons, but you never know with Scooby.
I don't believe he's going to show up.
I don't think he's going to show.
Based on what he's been telling me in Discord, so he doesn't plan on joining us.
Okay, so he has disagreed with the idea of joining. He is what do you call it? He's backed out. He's been a little pussy. He's a spineless bitch. His mother's probably disappointed in him. All those things. But since we do have AP here, although he has stepped away to make tinkles. Brockus, could you give us a summary of the case?
Make tinkles? Gotcha, K.
Make tinkles. Hey, we're talking about AP here. Yeah, he doesn't piss. Motherfucking makes tinkles.
That's okay. Fair enough. Yeah. So what? Full recap or just like the best parts?
I don't know. Give us a full recap, but like the short version.
Okay. Because all of this shit happened this year. Scooby comes onto the scene because he just so happens to actually know and somewhat be liked by Penoid, somebody who actually was a regular on our show and even became a co-host for a while because it's fucking Penoid. Why the hell don't you grab Penoid as an actual talent on your roster if you have the chance? Everyone should be grabbing Penoid as their fucking talent roster. Anyways, so Penoid actually hits us up and he vouches for Scooby and everything, but let's be fair, he had met him not too long ago this year. Well, I mean, at that time. It turns out Scooby has a bit of a dark side, and when I say dark side, I mean a fur side. No, he's not half black at all. He's got a fur side, a fag side, a side that makes everybody question not only his sanity, but his sexuality and a lot of other things.
In fact, giant fucking dildo.
He's got small-sized dick socks and giant fucking dildos. Yes, yes. That is, you shouldn't have small dick socks and giant dildos in your fucking Amazon wish list if you are a straight man, I think is what Brockus is trying to say.
Yeah, hey, if you're getting some little tiny fucking condoms and the giant-sized dildos, there's something going on there. You're probably at least a little bit of a gigantic faggot.
Yeah. Yeah, he has underwear on his wish list that are assless, so he can get fucked in his ass. Yeah, that's not a joke either.
Yeah, no, assless anything are not for straight men.
Yeah.
His daddy's fucking turning over in his grave saying, "I'm glad I left your mommy for smokes when you were 10.
No shit. Where is his fucking father, by the way? Is he dead? I hope he's dead. I hope you went through that pain, Scooby, you piece of shit.
No, I hope that his dad is dead so he didn't have to see his son turn out like this, you know?
Would it be worse if his dad was dead or if his father just fucking left and abandoned him because he couldn't stand the fucking hot gay
as
mess?
As long as he didn't need to see him grow up, good on him.
As long as it hurts Scooby, I'm happy with it.
But anyway, Brockus was given a summary of what Scooby's done. You might be better fit for this, AP.
Brockus is better for this. I'll just jump in if he misses something like that, and we'll go into Scooby 2 Electric Joogaloo.
There we go.
That's got to be one of the best parts because you see, Scoob decided that he wanted to lose his shit on one of our co-hosts, Leaf, and this is actually the very incident that caused us to even get to notice her, was because he was threatening her and one of her friends.
Well, we found Leaf through the Scooby thing because of the whole fucking you didn't get us enough views thing.
Exactly. See, Scooby apparently was supposed to go onto a stream, and by supposed to, I mean in his mind, he believed he was supposed to go onto a fucking stream with Leaf and a handful of friends for some birthday or something like that. While Leaf apparently either forgot to send it to him or was instructed specifically not to send the link to him, whatever the fucking case was, she didn't send him the goddamn link. Scooby did not take well to this, and he started taking to threatening her, which she just eventually ignored after she kind of spurred out on him, you know how Leaf spurgs, for a little bit of time, and eventually he let it go. I think it's the whole she's a girl and I'm supposed to have this idea of being a gentleman, so I shouldn't actually do this shit kind of idea.
But I think he's just jealous of women because they have vaginas, and that's what he wants more than anything.
Said to women, it's no gentleman type shit.
That's true. I was trying to play a little Scooby's advocate, but let's be honest.
If we're going to play Scooby's advocate, let's be honest about it.
Yeah.
The best I can argue for the motherfucker is that maybe his mom was a meth head. His father left her because he couldn't deal with that shit. So Scooby was left alone, raised by a meth head mother. And that, it'll destroy a kid. That's the best case scenario for Scooby.
I actually see Scooby's attitude today as a product of overcoddling. Very Norman Bates, shit like that.
Oh, yeah. I think in the other direction. She wasn't the beating you type of shitty mom. She was the, okay, come here, princess. You got beat up at school. Don't worry. Mommy still loves you.
Yeah, he would go upstairs, and then because he knows that no other woman would ever fucking have him, he just jacks off and thinks of his mom. Yeah, he's that guy.
I could see that. He does still
when
have
she
the
dies,
haircut.
He will keep her in the fucking attic and keep her room immaculate. That's the type of motherfucker this is right here.
He's still got the bull haircut. To that, to me, that says mom still cuts his hair.
And he's also brain
damaged.
That's
a special type of relationship.
Oh, and yeah, it's Uzi Q in the chat confirms his dad is dead. Good, Scooby. I'm glad your fucking dad's dead. I hope somebody killed him right in front of you when you were a kid, you motherfucker.
I wouldn't go that far, Scooby. I'm just glad he's dead so he doesn't have to see what you are now.
I hope someone slowly pissed him to death in a basement and made you watch, you piece of shit.
God damn.
But go on, Brockus.
You are real angry about a thing.
Not at all. If I was angry, I wouldn't have such control of my words, dude. You've seen me angry before. It's bad. This is just... I'm just tired of the guy, man. This shit comes out of nowhere.
AAP's not angry, Scooby. He's just disappointed.
Yeah, I'm just disappointed in you. Much like your father was before he died, disappointed in you. The last thought that went through your dad's head right before a bullet was, damn, my son is a worthless piece of shit. And I'm glad that I'm dying because I won't have to stay around and raise this worthless piece of shit and be to blame for it.
Those are a lot of words to write on one bullet.
I'm saying that's the thought that was going through his head before the bullet followed it shortly.
The bullet fucking hit, and his last words were, thank you, my son's a faggot.
Yeah.
Well, Jesus fuck.
So, Brockus, continue your story.
After some time of harassing and fucking threatening Leaf,
I have to pause you one more time, and I'm sorry about that. William, I'll tell you in private. Go on, I'm sorry.
Private for William.
Scooby eventually turned his attention to one of Leaf's friends over in the Gulf City Discord named Gulf City Viking, GCV. And GCV just decided, because he's a kid, that he's going to start trolling the shit out of
The motherfucker Scooby. That the night I met Leaf, like he was in tears and shit.
Because he was freaking the fuck out. Scooby had apparently gotten enough information on this kid to actually attempt a legitimate dox. And he even used it against him more than once. And basically, Scooby did not take too well to actually being trolled. Fair enough. Now, what Scooby did was not actually doxing. However, you can see that the motherfucker was definitely going to be looking into this kid and would definitely dox him and continue his threats and all kinds of crazy shit like that, which none of us took kindly to. So
it was about this time also that Scooby started DMing me on Discord. And all of you know, dude, Discord is the worst way to get a hold of me, dude. I don't look at Discord. I'm straight.
Yeah, Discord. But unless you're like always on Discord, you're probably never on Discord.
I'm actually going to pull it up right now so I can quote this shit because it is so fucking gay. Like, hold on a second.
Pull it right up, man.
It's something like he thought that Gulf City was like a gang and that if he just got, oh, he sent me another DM. Let's see what's going
on. You did call yourselves Whale Gang. You guys put the gang name out there.
Well, yeah, I guess that's kind of true, but that doesn't mean that I can tell people on the internet what to do. Scooby, I disavow nothing. I hope they trolled you to fucking death. I hold, to this day, I hold the whale gang close to my fucking chest. But in any case, it is, I cannot tell motherfuckers what to do and what not to do. So yeah, I got my DMs up now. He did DM me some stupid shit. Now I'll get to that here in a minute. He says, this was in, August. He hits me up and he goes, hey, I've been having problems the past few months with GCV. I tried being patient. I really did. I finally had enough and had to throw him out of my server today. This isn't going to cause a headache for you, is it? I understand he's your mascot or some such, which is why I asked. Which is like, at that point, I had talked to the kid like twice in my life, right? And then he says, you and I need to have a chat now. So I wrote back to him. I'm like, nah, I heard your threats. Fuck you. You're a phony. Make an idle threat. Because at this point, he had said that I've talked to my Hollywood union friends and now Gulf City's been blacklisted from Hollywood, ha ha ha, and they're gonna blame you, GCV. They're gonna fucking hate you for this shit. Trying to use us, who've really never, I hadn't really talked to the dude before. That's a recurring theme with Scooby, that whenever he sends you a fucking message, he says, well, I'm only fucking you up because of this other guy. He's like a 16-year-old. He thinks that you're gonna turn on people because they force Scooby's hand. You know,
no, I mean? And then it's not even that. He thinks that he's going to come to you, AP, and be like, AP, I'm only going after you because this guy's shitty.
Yeah, and I'm over here you're
going to fucking destroy that guy for me, so I don't have to destroy you, right?
Right, right.
And it's like, if I can fucking destroy that guy and you can fucking destroy me, why can't you destroy that guy?
Hey, yo, if you call off the 19-year-old kid who's trolling me, I'll fucking not go to my union friends in Hollywood, to which I responded, like, do whatever you fucking want. I don't believe you have any friends, much less friends in high places. So that, and that was my, at the time, I thought, the end with this motherfucker. But go on, Brock, because I wanted to tell the background between me and him at this point. I didn't really know who Scooby was. I hadn't crossed this fucking guy. His name had never come out of my fucking mouth, yet I was being threatened by this guy. When I was with Gulf City. And that caused some tension between me and Gasly, because if you know me and Gasly, you know that one of us is going to go on the internet and go at a motherfucker, aka AP. And Gasly is more like, dude, I just want to fucking
dude, we got to protect our brand.
Yeah, fuck this fucking kid, to his credit. And, you know, that is exactly how he wanted it to be. And that caused some tension between him and me at the time, because I was like, no, he's doxing irate prostate. He's going after Atima's fucking family. Fuck this. These people give us money, so I'm going to fucking do what I can for them. You know, and that's when the me and Scooby thing got started. So go on, Brockus.
So around the same time, it turns out that Scooby was actually also doing another show called Chaos 120 with Irate Bear. I'm sorry, not Irate Bear. Irate Prostate and Atema the Hun and a handful of others.
Oh, Irate Bear would have blocked him and not had anything to do with him the first day.
Very, very true. So he was doing this Chaos show with those two. And he was showing himself frequently on Cuntstream, and of course he was pissing the fuck off GCV and GCV's friends over in the Discord, which they all continued to then troll him afterwards. We eventually had this stream, not the Trial of Scooby, but a stream. I think we did label it the Trial of Scooby, where
the first one we did about Scooby with the.
But that was after he started threatening me with biker gangs, and he sent me my
after that.
Some random dude from Mickey Coy's crew had sent me my own address, to which he got the fucking response, motherfucker, I find this place drunk at night. I know where I live. What the fuck are you talking about? What they didn't know, because they didn't bother to Google map my home, is, and dude, Schmeckle, I'll do it for you after the show. I can throw a football and hit the police station. Like, for all the weed I smoke, believe it or not, I live literally.
Man, you just said you'll do it for me after the show. I hope to God you mean you're going to turn on your camera, throw a football, and hit the police shop with it.
I fucking could. I could get on my phone and I could show you how quickly. So when he starts talking about, we're going to send bikers to your house and they're going to fuck you up. If they don't come, I'm going to break your legs. I'm over here like, please send some bikers to rev up their fucking bikes in my front lawn, dude. What are they going to do? Bring their bikes to my front lawn and pull out some laptops? This is internet bullshit. So this guy, he's now threatened me with Hollywood unions and biker gangs and national socialists. So this guy is full of fucking shit to begin with. I've seen it a million times. I'm not intimidated by it. You know, I've just seen this shit since I started the internet, you know, back in 96 or whatever, you know, but like, other people who were involved in this shit. You know what I mean? Like Irate, but like Uzi Q, like Atima and her fucking family, like GCV are really either done with this shit or they are actually intimidated by it because they haven't, they're not creators in the same sense that like on the same level that me and Ghastly were, where I'm just used to getting threats every fucking day. Everyone in the chat, DM me a threat right now. I will type LOL at all of you back. And I mean some nasty threats. Send me that you're going to like fuck my mom on top of my dead body. I don't give a fuck.
I assume at least the four of us, we all get threats, right?
Yeah, every day. Every day.
Wouldn't say I get them every day, but yeah, you know, we've all had that shit.
I think one of the funniest and most painful threats anybody can fling at AP or even you, Schmeckle, is I'm going to break into your house, tie you up, and make you watch as I do all your drugs in front of you.
Yeah, that is a terrible threat.
That would hurt. That would hurt me. Hey, if you want to get up my heart, do that.
If you want to get fucking shot, just come to my fucking house, dude. Like, it's as simple as that. Our lives are very clear here in Texas, dude. I will not be the one going to jail if I wound you and you still live. It's going to be the game, dude. I will put you down. And Scooby, let me tell you that if you're listening right now, which I'm sure you are because you're a bitch made nigga, and you probably won't show up in the chat because you're scared everybody on the chat's going to call you a bitch made motherfucker.
Scooby, 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 Scooby. We know you're too much of a bitch to show up in the goddamn stream, even though you have the fucking link. Dongwave has sent you the fucking link. Mm-hmm. So there's no way you can say it's not you being a little bitch.
And he sent a link to your fat buck tooth gap like, fucking common household
we,
bitch.
We know you don't work.
Actually, I haven't sent
any. We know you
any...
don't have a girlfriend or nothing like that. You're living with your mother.
Because I have no fucking idea who Tara is.
Okay, Tara doesn't have the link.
But I did ask Scooby to forward the link to her, so maybe he did that. I don't know.
Yeah, and Tara, if you're listening right now, I'd sure love to see the proof that I said I was going to dox Scooby, because all of my communication with you has been in writing. So if I actually said that, Tara, it shouldn't today, while you were begging me to do shit, then, yeah, why don't you go ahead and just produce that? Come on here and produce where I said I was going to dox
Scooby. I'm going to be completely forthright about something. Most of you know this. I have no fucking loyalties to any of these cunts. You know, Brockus, obviously, because I love him. But the rest of these guys, fuck them. AP's not one of my guys.
Yeah,
he's
Schmeckle
not
will
part
throw
of
me
the fucking
up,
family.
Show some proof of me saying I'm going to
If it
dox.
Turns
He'll
out AP
a
is a fucking doxer, or even is threatening to dox somebody, I'll throw him under the bus right fucking now.
As well you fucking should.
Get so in Tara, here, show me the fucking evidence, and I will tear this guy a new one. I will make it publicly known that he is a fucking doxer.
That's my challenge to you, Tara Sin. Show the proof.
Jump in here right now. I know Brockus is the same way.
We know you're the fucking one that holds the...
Fuck AP.
I know you're the one that wears the pants in that little relation, that little fucking emotional connection you and Scooby had, because you're the one that's fucking DMing me to back off of him because he's so fucking scared. Cause he's not man enough to do it himself, so he sent a fat bitch.
Just an update. He said he sent
a message.
He said he'd send Tara the link, but he believes she's already in bed. So
Well, tell her to wake her fat ass up.
I'm gonna go ahead and send the link to that other guy we talked about.
This is important because Weebo's in the chat. It's actually important
they're not
that I talk
coming.
Right now because she has
school. They're not coming.
She has stuff to do in the daytime. So Weebo, no, I have no idea why he brought you up. He brought you up in that fucking thing and he's like, yo, I heard you want to fuck Weebo, but she's never going to fuck you. And I'm like, where that was out of left field like a motherfucker. I've talked to that chick twice in my life.
This guy knows two chicks on the internet and that's Weebo and Tara. He had to be realistic, so he picked Weebo.
Fair enough. But yeah, Weebo, I've never brought you up in any conversation. And that's not to insult you. That's not saying you're not worth being discussed, but you just don't come to mind. You and me don't run in the same circles. We don't really know one another. So yeah, that's that. I don't know why you were brought up either. And I can show you DMs where I'm like, what the fuck is this motherfucker talking about? Like, I don't fucking know. It's just like last time Scooby brought you up. He's trying to use your name to threaten people. The same as he tried to use
I heard
my name.
You want
to
fuck Weebo Jones. I'm going to fuck you over with
not,
this information.
Look, she's a cute girl, but I've just never fucking talked to her. She don't come to mind. Like, I don't think about people I don't talk to. Like, what?
That's exactly it. Like, Weebo, I'm sure you're a nice looking I've seen you. You are a nice looking girl.
Yeah, you're a cute chick, but we don't know one another. I don't know where you came from either.
Like, exactly. Like, you're not on the top of most people's minds that you don't speak to.
Yeah. I just wanted you, I didn't want you to think that I'm not ragging on you saying, I don't think about you. No, I mean, we just don't talk. So I don't, you know.
Yeah, I think she gets it. All right, cool. You're not being mean.
She's one of the few people on the internet that it's not doesn't deserve to have people be mean to her. So that's, you know.
No, I've only spoken to her a couple of times. She does seem like a very nice girl.
Yeah.
So. Now, to be fair, I don't think Weibo is banging anybody because I'm pretty sure she has no sex organs.
It's just a theory of mine.
I am fairly certain.
I hope Weibo you get laid. I don't care if you are. it's as out of left field to me as it is to you. All right, that's all I can say.
Oh, Weibo says she's not offended, just taken aback. AP does not want to fuck everything he meets, Weibo.
That takes me aback too. Yeah, I probably should try to get down. But you know what?
Up your game. You should be thinking that's about right. fucking yeah. Weibo.
I should be talking about I want to fuck every fucking chick I've ever talked to for 3 minutes on the fucking internet. Girl, Weibo.
Okay, we've talked to each other for five minutes. Well, we have American Phoenix in the chat. He says, Weibo is pretty hot, not as hot as Renalations or Atem of the Hun, but she is very beautiful. I would say Weibo is objectively more attractive than those two ladies.
Pretty sure those ladies would say Weibo's hotter than them too.
I'm not trying to talk about women's looks that I like and respect. That's something I reserve that for fat bitches.
I don't like or respect any of you.
She's asking if I disrespected the 87-foot dick. I'm not disrespecting anything. I just doubt its existence.
All right, well, enough of giving that we're trying to tell a story, so enough of giving the chat attention for now.
Back to Scooby, Baracus.
Yeah, yeah. So Scooby's doing Chaos 120. He's also doing shows with us. He ends up getting trolled by GCV. He creates this big stink about a lot of bullshit, all because he is silently threatening the shit out of GCV. Eventually, Leaf brings this to our attention, which we then start asking questions for. He doesn't like this. He continues to threaten GCV in secret, thinking that GCV is not going to fucking tell anyone anything, which was really dumb of him, because GCV ended up telling a bunch of people.
Came right to me. And I'm like, I don't know what I can do for you, man. If the motherfucker talks to me, I'll tell him to go fuck himself, which I did. And I thought it was over.
But so he just gets trolled harder and harder, and he causes an even bigger fucking problem. Hence the part two, which we inevitably did officially dub the Trial of Scooby, because a lot of things started to come out.
A lot of things.
After being threatened a number of times, some of these people, including myself, typed Scooby331 into Google. Mm-hmm. And just by doing that, we found out a lot
of goddamn things.
Yeah, his Furfinity is under Scooby331. His Amazon wish list with all the dildos and fur bag suits and lingerie with and men's underwear for gay men with butthole holes in the back and shit like that. Dick's extra small size dick socks. That's what made me laugh the hardest. I'm like, this motherfucker just gave us the size of his little dick. But yeah, all that shit was there. His Furfinity, his DeviantArt, all was under Scooby331. And yeah, we had the Trial of Scooby, and we outed that motherfucker as a fake ass fucking gangster who hangs with National Socialists, reads books about how to be a better fucking Jew. Then he tries to T-Tack and dual wield. He's trying to hook them up with his quote unquote rapper friends. At the same time, he's hanging out with legit Nazis. I'm not saying that like an Antifa would say that. Like, these people will tell you, yes, we are National Socialists.
People are full out like, you know, Heil Hitler type shit.
Yeah, they are the Heil Hitler crowd, you know? So it's kind of funny that he's hanging out with Mickey Coy, who I've also found out Mickey Coy has publicly stated that his son, that the furries tried to recruit his son, which makes it funny to me that he would be hanging out with a fucking closet fur bag like Scooby, but that's a whole nother fucking story. We found his furry fucking deep furfinity, all his DeviantArt furry shit, all his the costumes, the dildos, the lube.
On the fucking Amazon with the big thing.
Oh, now, yeah, please. After this, go back and watch the Trial of Scooby. It was an excellent stream to wreck a motherfucker on.
I think it might have actually been on the old channel, but I'll get Anon to re-upload it tomorrow.
Yeah, I believe the video should still be called the Trial of Scooby, which, by the way, I have to give a lot of credit to Joseph Kerwin. He was one of the people that just so happened to have stumbled across a lot of this information, which...
Yeah, Joseph Kerwin, that motherfucker that gives us money all the time. He also gave us, like, all of this shit.
About well, let's be fair. I found the Amazon. Oh no, he found it. He gave it to me, and like me and fucking three or four people in a Google Hangout just went through it for an entire night, laughing. I'll never forget that night, dude. We were laughing so fucking hard.
Gave the shit to us too. If it weren't for Joseph Kerwin, we wouldn't have had that fucking laugh fest.
All he did was a quick fucking Google search, found I think five relevant links, sent them to the appropriate people, the CunStream crew and fucking AP and his group, and that's when everybody went digging.
The forensics teams were put on the case.
Yeah. Oh my God. We had a fuck. I think the thing that surprised everybody the most was the giant fucking dildo, because no one really expected that to be on
And it was on the wish list right above the lube. So he put them on right next to one another. He's like, I need this big dildo, but I'm also going to need this lube to go with it.
I tried so hard to make the argument. Maybe it was just a fucking like statue or something. Like they wanted it for decoration.
I thought maybe because it was so big that maybe it was like a novelty he was going to put it in like a man cave or something and like throw it at his friends or something. But then I found out he lives with his fucking mom. He still sleeps in the same room his bassinet was in, dude. Like at 40
years
old.
You know why? He tries to pass it off like, oh, you know, mom's sick. She's old. I got to take care of her. No, it's because he's not a man. He's never been a man. He passed the point where you're supposed to become a man, and then 22 years later, he's still not a man.
Yeah, we found out the size of your dick, Scooby. That fucking ship where you could have been thought a man has sailed, Mr. Extra Small Dick Sock.
I think
I would like to point out
penises from 2 to 4 inches, dude.
I would like to point out, just in case any of the YouTube fucking guys are watching, we are not bullying this man. This is all information he's made public and seems to be quite proud about.
Yeah, I'm not insulting him. I'm just describing him.
No, yeah, fair enough, fair enough.
It's only me. You are a bigot against people that are like him.
Now, this is just a theory, but I think he may have initially decided he wanted the giant dildo because he heard about Weebo Jones' immaculate apparent dildo, which
he had penis envy.
Again, I cannot confirm nor deny its existence. Weebo has yet to show me any kind of proof, so I don't believe that dick exists, Weebo.
Well, she has offered me some dick in the chat, so I'm gonna try this out for myself, man. I hear it's a very feminine penis, so we're gonna.
I hear AP is out to fuck you, so now's your chance.
Yeah, I mean that's like the least. I heard you wanted to fuck a woman. I'm like, I heard you wanted to fuck men.
I heard you sometimes wear a fursuit.
Yeah, you fuck men in a fursuit. I don't think you get to look down on the straight community, Scooby.
Somebody do me a favor. Send a link to The Killing Joke. I've seen that guy on the Kumite. I love his voice.
Don't know
if I like him yet, but I love his voice.
Nah, he's a cool dude, man. I bust his balls sometimes when he's in the chat, but that's only because I like him enough to bust his balls. It's not a hateful ball busting.
While you're doing that, I got to piss. AP's in charge.
All right. Well, why don't you lay out more of the fucking story so we can get up to the current times and we can talk about what happened over the last 3 days, Brockus.
No, yeah, fair enough. So, pretty much after the trial of Scooby on the CunStream, which blew the fuck up and exposed him for all the insanity that he was trying to keep secret, it eventually rolls over to another channel where apparently another group of people were actually trying to give him more of a chance to actually explain himself with Tyro and Lo-Fi. And
was it Addy on that one, I think?
I don't believe Sir Adamantine was
there. Or the next 6 minutes, because one of them was giving him like a fair fucking shake, and the other one was like somebody else jumped in there like, fuck you, Scooby.
No. I think I remember now. It was Anti-Hero who was actually giving him a relatively fair shake, but the way he was doing it was by leading him down a specific path of questioning to inevitably bring up the fact that he's a piece of shit human being. It's kind of like, I'm going to expose you for the horrible cunt you are, but I'm going to do it in a really nice way. I'm going to do it with a fucking smile on my face. And after he was done with his series of questioning, he eventually stepped down and let others actually take over. A handful of others took over. Atema got a couple of shots in, which was...
Oh, I got a couple of shots, and I ran him off that fucking stream. And as soon as I left, he came back on, and I came right back on that stream. Like, I'm everywhere, motherfucker. You ain't never going to escape me. And then he ran off again like the little bitch he is. Yeah, right, now he just sent me another DM on Discord saying, I heard you agreed to box me. You set up the time. You fucking come up here any fucking time. I'm like, dude, I'm not. I didn't challenge you to a boxing match. You challenged, so you're going to have to fucking set that shit up. In fact, I'll be in Knoxville on January 19th. Scooby, all you got to fucking do is January 20th, find a gym that has a boxing ring. And I will pay for both of our days memberships to that. And I will offer you to fight bare knuckle. And I will fight with 16-ounce gloves, heavyweight gloves that are well above my weight division. And I will still beat your fat, crippled ass to death.
You know what, AP? I'm going to break your legs and call the FBI or whatever. Let's fight. You pay for my flight.
Yeah, right? That's exactly what he said. Like, I'm going to come kill you, but you pay for my fucking flight. I'm like, what the fuck? Who are you? I came from the time on the internet.
I didn't even know that was what Scooby had pulled. I was making Scooby, a legitimate offer.
I'm 37. You're fucking 40, okay? We come from around the same age. I'm from the time on the internet where if you get someone to try to fight you IRL because you troll them so hard, you win. I'm not Tonka Saw. I'm not going to set up a fucking sanctioned fight for you and me to get down. But if you're in the same city I am at the same time and you know where there's a fucking gym, all right, let's go. I'll take 19 seconds out of my day to lay you out.
Yeah, you don't need a fucking sanctioned fight to fight in the ring at a gym.
Yeah, we can just go in there. It's called sparring, man.
Yeah.
I'll just break your fucking jaw and call an ambulance for you and everything. It'll be fine. They'll wire that fucking jaw shut so you finally stop running your fucking mouth. In fact, from now on, Scooby, shut your fucking mouth when you talk to me.
Well, that's exactly what he did with the string that followed after the Tyro and Lo-Fi one, because Tyro and Lo-Fi ran one to actually try to, you know, better help Scooby explain himself, which, again, was exposed for being the piece of shit that he was brilliantly by Antihero, I might add. Shortly after that, there was another stream hosted by Sir Adamantine and I want to say Trippy. I think it was just those two, which you made an appearance on, AP. This is where they were talking to Scooby, and as soon as you showed up, as soon as your avatar, your icon popped up on the screen, he was gone. Fucking hang up button.
Yep, he can't hang up button. The bants were a little too much for him.
5 seconds.
Everything is a little too much for that motherfucking pussy. He won't even come on here when I promise him that I'll speak nicely to him.
Yeah, if he comes on here tonight, I won't insult him. I just have some legit questions for him. Like, Scooby, after me not talking about you, not even thinking about you for 4 months, why the fucking 112 message deep thread that, like, seriously, like, unanswered messages. I ignore this motherfucker. I got 112 unanswered Discord messages right now from this motherfucker. And he's got the nerve to be like,
112.
Yeah, and he's got the nerve to be like, I'm reporting you guys to the FBI for cyberbullying. I'm like, please do. Please do, because I do have your information. And when they fucking call me about it, I'm going to give them everything we fucking have. Prove that you're actually just a brain damaged retard dumbass spurging out on the fucking internet. And then you're going to, in the state of New York, and... Thank you. I've been drinking, so I forget who gave it to us. But yeah, thank you for telling me the law about that. Because in New York, if you falsely report to a federal agency, you're the one that goes to jail. Scooby, you aware of that? Also, Scooby, when you said you were going to come break my legs, are you aware that you broke New York law? You're not going to break my legs because obviously I'm still walking around on two legs, you dumb fake bastard.
AP, but yeah, I'll break your legs, though.
No, you won't.
We'll face each other in the ring, and I'm gonna break your back.
No, Schmeckle, you don't have the will, skill, or fucking ability to do so. But I appreciate you trying.
I don't have the last two things, but I'm full of will. Actually, it sounds like a lot of work.
You're full of William Stinch ever? Yeah, he's gonna stress that butthole out for you.
So yeah, no, I just had to confirm with the chat that it was actually the Adamantine and Trippy Poop fucking stream. I was not sure.
Yes,
I forgot.
It was Trippy stream.
So. That stream happened, and then nothing.
Sparky Stackhorn, thank you, sir.
Nothing for months. This was the last existence of Scooby in everyone's mind, because once you fucking hit the hang up button, as soon as AP shows up, 5 second fucking kumite, fastest kumite ever. Once that happened, Scooby just completely disappeared, and we thought we were done with him for good.
Well, that's the thing. We all thought we were done with him. We got Jacob Navo in the chat. He says, is the Scooby situation over now? First off, somebody mute Jacob Navo just because I don't like him.
No, man.
He's fucking back. Scooby's pulling more shit. We all thought he had gone, but he's not. He's still here. He's still around. He's still trying to cause shit.
He's just the worst lolcow.
Significant he is.
He's like Christy Winters or one of those one of those lolcows, dude.
AAP, I think we can agree. The Snatch Cast, pretty insignificant, right?
I wouldn't go that far. Rather insignificant, yes.
Rather insignificant.
I don't want you to give yourself a little credit. It's just like, rather.
There's nothing pretty going on here.
Exactly. Well, we got nothing pretty going on here. But the, like with Scooby, he's insignificant to the point where it's like, all right, you're literally reaching nobody. You're reaching a group of like 10 of your friends and that's it. There's no audience for you. What the fuck is this burgery about? Are you trying to build an audience? Wrong way to go about it. Are you just trying to start shit? Nobody cares about you to go through shit with you.
Yeah, I sent the
actual threats to go to the FBI and shit. It's like,
if he wasn't such a good time to talk about and expose, then yeah, I would have just fucking ignored the whole thing. But he is, I won't block him on Discord. I could just block him and not hear from him anymore. But by God, I just can't wait to see what he says next. You know,
I never block people for exactly that reason. Eventually, they're gonna say something dumb that I'm gonna find funny.
I sent the link to Joker. Unfortunately, he can't make it tonight. He's incapacitated.
Okay, no worries, Joker.
Hey, man, you go over your handlebars head first. I'll give you a pass. That's fine.
But as far as Scooby goes, I don't know at this point if it's attention seeking or if he's just dumb enough that he thinks he's actually going to win this fight.
It's either liquor or cocaine or manic depression. And he just hit a manic period the other day.
I've done liquor. I've done cocaine. I never done manic depression. So I'm thinking maybe it's the third.
I've done all three. And when you mix them, you become Hitler. Trust me, dude. Hey, Schmeckle, fuck you and your cute girlfriend. You know what I mean? Like,
it just seems ridiculous. It's been what, like 4 or 5 months since the last time we talked about Scooby Brockus?
He was forgotten. We were done.
After his last appearance, it was decidedly so that Scooby was beneath everyone. He was the lowest fucking form, this amoeba of a creature underneath even the fucking dirt we walk on. He was nothing to anyone. Absolute nothing.
He's still nothing to anyone.
Let me see if he blocked me again, because he's asked me if I will accept this fucking fight and pay for it.
Dong Wave, send him the motherfucking link again.
Yeah, let me see if he's blocked me. Because
come on, I'm going to tell his mom that he's not a man.
I'm typing it right now, but I'm probably
He knows that AP knows who he is. He doesn't know that I don't know who he is. Tell him that if he doesn't show up, I'm going to tell his mother that he's not a real man.
No, what I just wrote to him is, why don't you come on the Snatchcast? I won't insult you. Let's talk this shit out. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not, because he ain't going to come if he thinks I'm going to roast him, dude. You know what I mean? Which I'm not going to do. I really do want to find out what's going to say.
At the very worst.
Yeah, but he challenged me to a boxing match just now and then blocked me, so I can't accept it or not, dude. Like, I don't know what to do with this fucking
AP,
guy.
I will. That boxing match, I'll fight you. You pay for my...
All right, come to Knoxville. I'll knock you out. No problem. Yeah, you pay for my fight. We're both a couple of fucking shit-talking drunks. I just need a vacation. I know the right combination of Vicodin and other narcotics to make it to where you can hit me in the head as much as you want and I'll fucking laugh, so that may not be a good idea for you.
Motherfucker, do you know how many drugs I've done in my life? Look at me.
Both of you are a prime example of trial and error.
Yeah, we're really bad people, Schmeckle. We shouldn't brag about this shit.
We are kind of shitty people, aren't we?
The only reason we like one another is because no one else likes us.
That's why we get along. We got this fake beef, but if we ever met up, we would be real life lovers because we're all we got. Because
we all know the we both know the other one has the coke.
Hey, it sucks in the aftermath when we both look each other dead in the eyes and go, okay, where is it?
No, it really sucks is when we both find ourselves naked in the bathroom talking about our lives at 6 a.m. and we're like, damn, neither one of us can ever stream about this.
That was a night we weren't supposed to mention.
You're assuming it wouldn't be on stream.
I rest my case. Why it's a bad idea. Anyway, let's go back into Scooby. We're telling people the story of Scooby. So we've gotten all the way up to now. Scooby has now threatened people with biker gangs by, what was his name? Burnside's biker gang. And I'm pretty sure if Burnside really does belong to an MC, they don't want a guy like Scooby threatening people on the internet with their MC.
Well, so no, that's the thing. Yeah, the bikers, he says he's in the mob. One thing I gotta ask right
he
now.
He talks too much to be involved with any of these things.
You guys have all heard a little bit about the mob, right?
Yeah.
You maybe seen The Godfather, Goodfellas, something like that, right?
Yeah. I
some of us more than
ever heard of the whole idea of Omerta? Like the idea where you keep your goddamn fucking mouth shut.
Well, he's not a made man. That would be something that you swear to get made. But yeah, you're still supposed
to get made. But I mean, if you're friends with the FBI, you're not friends with the mob too.
Yeah, no shit. This guy's a mob guy. He's all connected, but he's also fucking ratting people out to the FBI. Way to go, Henry Hill.
Yeah, anyway. He's no Capone. He's a fucking Pistone. He's fucking Donnie Brasco.
Yeah, fucking
a Capone.
He is. He's a fake. That's all it is.
Yeah, he'll tell you anything. He'll tell you anything. He is a legit. I'd really never met a lolcow, a lying, pathological lolcow until I met Scooby. I've never seen anything like this before where he'll threaten you in the same week. He'll threaten you with the mob, unions, skinheads, and the feds. And none of these are real threats. And if they were real threats, it would always blow back on him. I'm going to send the mob after you. When the mob gets the door and I'm like, yeah, the whole internet knows you're coming. If anything happens to me, you're going down because Scooby ran his fucking mouth. He's getting a bullet in the fucking head from those guys. The same with fucking skinheads. The same with the AB. Oh, yeah, he's threatening motherfuckers with the AB. Yeah, like, I'm not in prison, dipshit. All right. Now, and yeah, by the way, have you watched my show, Scooby? If anyone is going to, if anyone has a white nationalist following, with their fucking show, it's more likely to be me than you. All right, you know the bell. So yeah, you're not scaring anybody, Scooby. Nobody. You're as transparent as a fucking clean window, dude.
That's the thing, Scooby. You realize to real white supremacists, you being
you're not even white. So real shit. White supremacists.
Exactly. But you don't fit the bill. And you know, white supremacy, obviously wrong and all that. But I mean, Scooby does not fit the bill for the type of white that they want.
And he also has sent me, Tom P, Sir Adamantine, somebody else today that I can't remember their name right now. Probably Irate didn't send me screenshots, but he did DM me like, is Scooby fucking with you again? But then I put it on Twitter so that he may or may not have. I didn't confirm with him. But yeah, all of them, here's the number to the agent that's investigating you. And Scooby, because I got your fucking docs, dude, I could immediately see the name on that agent and go, what, is this your brother's cell phone or something? Like, come on, dude. Try harder.
That's the thing. He gave you an actual number in the agent's name.
Yeah.
And that's like, something you realize we can look up what the fucking number is, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Scooby.
You got a case against this guy. First off, I don't think the FBI actually builds the cases for you. I think you go through a lawyer and all that. But if you're dealing with the FBI, first thing they're going to tell you is, hey, don't share this fucking number because it's for you to contact, not for you to, for some reason, give out to the bad guy in the situation.
Don't partake in unsolicited harassment using my fucking name and number. It's like when somebody says, I've got a lawyer and start telling you a bunch of shit. And you're like, well, now I know you don't have a fucking lawyer because the first thing a lawyer would tell you to do is shut the fuck up. Let him do the talking.
To be fair, you can have a lawyer and be stupid.
Fair enough. Fair enough. Kurt Cobain was suicidal and also murdered at the same time by Courtney Love. So
he suicided himself from an angle that most of us couldn't. He was double jointed.
No. Okay. Fair enough. Yeah. If that would have to be how it was to spin a fucking shotgun 180 degrees in the other way after you were dead and you're clinching that motherfucker.
He was double jointed and had like a 15 second buffer before death.
Yeah, and then after he shot himself in the head, he wiped down the fucking shotgun. Yeah, that's the first, so there was no prints on it. Yeah,
you know what? Maybe he became a ghost.
After injecting 10 times the amount of after injecting 10 times the amount of heroin in his arm, where every fucking expert ever that has ever been questioned about this says he probably should have passed out before he fucking finished pushing the plunger in. Yeah, no, well, Kurt Cobain was murdered, but that's not what we're here to talk about.
His blood was just good at absorbing heroin.
Hey, I think we all have.
High.
That's my new excuse, man. Hey, my blood is just really good at absorbing cocaine.
That's, you know what? I have a feeling that at least one cop is going to hear that and just be like, you know what? That's good enough for me. On your way, sir.
Come on, bring it the fuck on. There's no drugs in my house at all. Just come on, bring it. It's about to be my weekend, so, you know, like, there's no partying happening around here.
Exactly. You get rid of that shit before the kids come by, then you buy new shit on Monday.
And the cocaine thing, I'm joking around, dude. If there was anything they would find, it would be weed, and I would get a fucking ticket. So go fuck yourself on that.
Weed's legal here now, man.
No, funny thing, while he's sending a fucking phone number to an FBI agent, apparently. And the phone number of an FBI agent, making vague threats at Atena yet again, basically talking shit on Irate Prostate, threatening fucking to send somebody to hack Leaf up and everything. He sends me, I believe, Penoid, and a handful of other people, including AP, a link to an FBI fucking website where you can actually report internet cyberbullying. Crime, cyberbullying, cyber and the things of that sort. And
as I'm if like, that's followed up on.
I'm like, are you fucking serious?
You know, somebody who goes to so many MAGA rallies and considers themselves a conservative, you sure don't know very many people in law enforcement, Scooby, but I do. I live right next to their station. I talk to them all the fucking time, man. I walk over there in the morning all the fucking time. And yeah, I guarantee you that cyberbullying thing, it isn't followed up on in 99% of all cases. It's got to be pretty fucking serious for the feds to get involved in somebody calling you a faggot on the internet.
Well, yeah, no, pretty much. It's a cyberbullying fucking website. They probably have it there out of obligation where they have an entire crack team of one guy who just kind of opens every email that comes through and never actually does anything with it.
Yeah, and then he sends his fucking fat bitch to try to talk to me. He sends that fucking, what's her name?
Don't ever send a fat bitch to do a man's job. Not because women can't do what men can do, but because nobody's going to respect a fat bitch.
This bitch is so fat, she leaves footprints in the goddamn sidewalk when she walks, man. But she's going to come over here and tell me something about how Scooby... No, please, just begging the fuck out of me. It didn't work, when I was like, fuck you and Scooby, you know what I mean? This bitch is like, she makes a video. She made a video tonight talking about fucking AP is gonna dox me and Scooby tonight, and she's gonna ruin my trip up to go live with Baronside in fucking Chicago. I'm like,
I want to ask. I want to ask you about in a minute, but I want to make something clear, Scooby. If you're gonna go ask after people for the fucking cyberbullying thing, put me at the top of your list, because although I'm not bullying you, I am going to be doing something a lot meaner than any of the rest of these cunts have done. So I'm going to be saying some mean things about him in a rhythmic fashion, perhaps over a beat.
Oh, indeed.
and it's going to be, it's considerably longer from what I've got so far than most of the diss tracks I've done. And it's very, very, very mean. It's not a nice track, Scooby.
Oh, also, as long as we're talking about Terrasen and her server, Terrasen runs a fucking, apparently, a doxing server now. Because she admits openly that Scooby was out there throwing around my name and my picture and my information in that fucking server. She just calls it roasting, though. And I'm like, they didn't even roast me. I've seen the screenshots. They're like, look at this big forehead having motherfucker. And I'm like, nigga, I talk about my big forehead all the time.
Your name is Joseph. Roasted.
Roasted, dude. I love how he states the obvious with such a sense of discovery. And by the way, Scooby, that's a picture of me at a business opening, something you will never be a fucking part of. And everybody in that picture.
I wouldn't say that, man. I've been part of business openings and my life sucks.
Well, this is a real business opening, though. Well, my life sucks too. And sometimes businesses go under. You know what I mean? Not every business is going to work. You don't make it 2 years, you're not in. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. I'm just saying, dude. Like, I wonder who ties this motherfucker's shoes for him in the morning, really. Is like,
he lives with his mother. Who the fuck do you think ties his shoes?
No, it's the only way he's going to get his dick close to a woman.
Old ass back. Because again, he's 40. So his
mom, can you put my dick sock 60. On for me? I'm a real paisan.
Tie his shoes and slide it over his cock.
I'm a real paisan. Put my dick sock on for me, mommy.
Oh, yeah. From what I hear, you're a fake paisan, AP.
Yeah, that's another thing I say all the time, that I'm half Italian and half bald Irish prick. Like, I never claimed to be a paisano. You motherfucker, I'm from Texas. There ain't no paisans down in Texas, all right? Unless they just moved here from Jersey, you stupid motherfucker. I'm half Irish. Why do you think my last name is McIntyre, you know what it is. Prick?
Sometimes you and Gasly used to do that bit where you'd go, oh.
Yeah, that makes us paisans.
Yeah, you guys are paisans now.
Tom P is 10 times the Italian I am, dude. We can just talk because I got 50% Italian blood. It's still enough to whoop your ass, Scooby. Make no mistake.
Yeah, hey, you know what? Someone send Tom P a link. Scooby ain't going to be showing. You're all free to invite Tom P in here to talk about Scooby. You guys can all invite whoever at this point. It's clear that Scooby and his crowd ain't going to be showing.
No, dude. Know? Those bitches, they ain't going to do shit, dude. Because that's all Scooby does is talk shit. He'll send you, like, he sent me a message, like, I'll box you, motherfucker. That was the last message he sent. Then he blocked me, so I couldn't be like, okay. Like, that's the kind of bitch we're dealing with.
Hold on. Let's give a slight benefit of the doubt. Maybe he meant to say, I'll block you, and the autocorrect fucked him up.
I don't think that's maybe how so. Autocorrect
you're really reaching to try to make Scooby into some kind of fucking halfway man out here. And I don't think that he's, you know, he's not even an asshole, man. He's an ass half, an ass quarter, an ass eighth.
Yeah,
he is. Honestly, this is the worst lolcal I've ever fucking encountered on the fucking internet, guys. Like, I've never
talked to somebody this far.
Who's worse? Who lies more than him? Fucking John Ross? The only one
Will Cato comes to mind, just with the ones we've dealt with. Fucking Zeph and Norian.
This guy, no. This guy's worse than Zeph.
You think?
At least Zeph can do something. You know what I mean? Like
that's true. Zeph does have some. Zeph now. Fuck you, Scooby.
Yeah, Zeph can actually could really hunt you down and find your information. Scooby can't even get that right. He's like, hey man, I found your fucking name and your fucking picture. I'm like, you mean the name that's on the credits of every fucking cartoon that we made before I left Gold City?
That's in the credits and the fucking and, face and I've shown on screen.
The picture of the face that I revealed on four fucking streams? Ooh, you got me now.
Yeah, your face has been out there so many times. It's been on the cunt stream.
I'm a pretty motherfucker. The only thing wrong with me is my fucking
forehead. You are not a pretty big ass forehead. You got the hair, motherfucker.
Roses are red. Violets are blue. I'm a pretty motherfucker, Scooby. What is wrong with you? That's my rap for him. That's a little poem I wrote. I was thinking about Scooby all day because I was at the zoo with the monkey cages, and that poem came to mind.
I only think of Scooby in the shower.
If I looked like Scooby, I wouldn't be calling the FBI on people. I would want to sue my fucking parents. He's lucky they say beauty is on the inside. You know what I mean?
And yeah, you know what the worst thing is? In all the streams, he has this fucking mask on his face, right? But him and his guys are still bothered by the fact that you use an avatar, despite the fact your face has been out there.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's how a locale operates. I wouldn't be surprised. There's nothing I would be surprised to hear about Scooby. Oh, and Scooby and Terrison, your little friend that you're trying to put a $200,000 fundraiser together for, and only were able to get $150 from three people that you all know personally, I'm here to tell motherfuckers out in public that is probably not a legit fundraiser. Do not give any money to anything that Scooby is fucking promoting, because everything I've ever known about that motherfucker is a lie. Same goes with Tara Sin as of today after that little video she put out that I'm going to go ahead and fucking mirror on my channel, because fuck her. Since they want to fucking give my channel a strike, I'll give them a reason to take down the Bloodstream channel. I will re-upload your fucking video there. Because guess what, you dumb motherfucker? I don't even stream from that channel, you stupid son of a bitch.
I'm going to give a little bit more of a reasonable...
And now Tara Sin's on my fucking make fun of this bitch list, too. So you put her on there. So let me play your little game, Scooby.
One goddamn second. As far as the donation thing goes, go ahead and donate if you think it's real. Be prepared for your money to possibly be stolen. I don't know if it's fake. It's coming from people that I don't trust. It's run by Terra Sin. But, you know, maybe that guy was actually hit by a car, whatever the fuck he says. And there's a comment here in the chat. Rakus Network says, better than Schmeckle. Poor looks like he got passed over for Sting from Guns N' Roses. Sting was not from Guns N' Roses, you dumb motherfucker.
What did you, what, do you mean Slash?
Slash and Sting are different people.
I think that they meant Slash.
Did you mean maybe Duff? I guess maybe a little bit, but more like Slash.
Maybe Slash or Duff, but certainly not Sting.
Where's Izzy? Guns N' Roses fans from the 80s will get that one. One in the chat if you get the
weird. Where's Izzy? He literally drank until his fucking liver burst. Oh, that's where's Izzy.
Oh, got a fucking GNR fan here.
Oh, wait, no, that was actually Duff, not Izzy. Never mind.
No, you were in the band. Put your hat on, Schmeckle. Let everybody know who you really are.
The hat is feet away from me. I could grab it if I wanted to.
No, I like the Pirate Jesus thing you have going on, man. I like it much better.
I only look like Jesus because I happen to wear a white shirt today.
Don't you hate it when you're trying to insult somebody and you just fuck it up like that guy just did in the chat?
Exactly. If you hadn't said Sting, it would have been an okay insult.
All right, it's Emma got it. Alex Martin got it. Good to see. Sting was in the Police, says Adrian Blom. That is correct. That is correct.
Someone invited Tama on. I'm not a big fan of the chick, but she has some history with Scooby, I think.
Oh, yeah, she does. Scooby has threatened her family, her children, and yet he still has the fucking nerve to say, I'm going to the FBI to report you guys. You're the only one doing illegal shit.
Scooby than I thought. Jesus Christ.
Oh, he's a piece of shit, dude. That's all he does is threaten people from across the country. That's all he's worth. I've seen video of this man at MAGA rallies. It's on fucking Terrasin's channel. You can all go see it now. This motherfucker is about 300 pounds of chewed bubblegum propped up on two fucking toothpicks with a cane. And he's out here trying to be like, oh, yo, I'll box you. I'm a real paisan. Motherfucker, please. It would be irresponsible for me to fight you. No sanctioned fight would ever fucking have it. But you know what, man? Hey, I'll give it to you, dude. If you're in Knoxville at the same time I am, we can take our ass down to Gold's Gym, and I will knock you out in that fucking ring. And then I'll piss on you afterward. How's that? How's that for you?
I need the money for a trip down to Knoxville.
Well, you better get a fundraiser going, man.
Rockets, start up a fundraiser. I'm going to fight AP.
I will.
Do it.
I just want to make sure that I'm not going to...
I've made it clear very, very, very many times that I am completely okay with getting hit in the face a bunch if I get money afterward.
Oh, it would break my heart to punch you, Schmeckle, dude.
I know. Yeah, you'd be sitting there. You'd be like, I don't want to do this.
Crying with every punch. Why do you make me do? Why do you make me hit you, Schmeckle? Pow.
I only do this because I love you.
Right, I'm only doing it. This is how much I love you, Schmeckle. Pow. Oh, man, I would love to introduce Scooby to Mr. Overhand Wright. But you know what, man? We're all just talking shit. That ain't never going to happen. That's a running from every confrontation he's ever been in, motherfucker. That motherfucker runs faster than refugees from a tear gas canister, dude. He just can't. This bitch-made lolcow, he's worthless. Utterly fucking worthless. Nothing but a fucking shit-talking, idle-threatening, bitch-made, fat, fake, phony motherfucker. Now, and Don I wouldn't Wave, even be on here talking all this shit.
One second, AP. Dawnwave, can you do me a favor and just keep sending him the link along with the mean things that we say about him? Maybe that'll incentivize him.
No, tell him I give him my word. Say I give him my word. I will not go and insult him. You know what I mean? Like
I will be as nice as I can possibly can.
Tell him AP will not insult him. AP will just... I've just got a couple of questions for him. They will not contain cuss words. It won't be insulting. I just got a question. What the fuck took you till December when the last time anyone thought about you was August to start threatening people with the FBI and you're going to come kill them and you want to fuck Weebo Jones? What if I did? Ask yourself that. Let's say I did. Is that an insult?
Like, you want to fuck a girl who's over 18?
My reputation? Sure, oh, no.
How dare you, sir?
The guy with the show full of butt cheeks based on cars and guns and people getting hurt and bitches I want to fuck. Oh, my reputation. Shut the fuck up, Scooby. Jesus Christ, dude. You fucking You are so juvenile, man. Like, and that's coming from the fucking host of the bloodstream.
That's another way. Like, you and me are very similar. There's no fucking embarrassing either of us. We do a good job of that ourselves.
Yeah, I come out every fucking night and do my show and say, my audience is smarter than me. I am a piece of shit. I'm extremely fucking mentally ill. There's nothing you've got on me, dude, that I haven't already fucking told the audience. Name something. Please, come in here and embarrass me, Scooby. Please do it.
I want to see what you think. Your ex was less than savory.
Yes, yes. She became a fat bitch, dude. Like, she's like...
drugs sometimes.
Oh, yeah. And then she stabbed me. And I never once laid hands on her. And I didn't call the police either because I didn't...
I'm sorry, actually. If my ex, even my most recent, the mother of my fucking kid, had stabbed me in the chest, I'd probably hit her a couple times because she stabbed me in the fucking chest.
It's like 8 Mile now, man. Come tell these people something they don't know about me. Come on, motherfucker.
Oh, are we doing fucking 8 Mile here? Yeah. Scooby and AP are gonna have a fucking rap battle. Right. Get Scooby on here or he's a bitch-ass nigga.
Scooby's small dick stock screaming, Scooby, I don't fit you!
Scooby, if you don't show up right now, I think it's fairly fucking certain that you've just given up any chance you have at being seen as a man. I mean, this is a very, like, there aren't many viewers here. We got nobody real, like, the most high-profile person here is AP.
Yeah, and I'm not even high-profile. I get
regular guest slots on the kill stream.
Or fucking Dongwave, whichever.
That's true. Dongwave does have friends in high places.
This ain't a high fucking risk, is what I'm saying. Scooby, jump on here. Don't be a bitch. We promise.
Be a man and come here and fucking settle some
beef. Goddamn mother proud. You're leeching off of her, living in her fucking house. Give her a reason to be fucking proud of you. Maybe your daddy will come back.
I'd send him the link, but the last time you had me send him something, he said I woke him up and he's going to bed.
Just keep sending him the link. I don't care. Funny, we're not respecting this motherfucker.
Just a minute ago to fucking send me a fucking challenge to boss.
There you go. Keep sending him the goddamn link. Tell that motherfucker to get his ass here and prove that he has a set of testicles and a mother who loves him. I'll be right back. I'm going to smoke. Fucking one of you's in charge.
Brock is being in charge.
Bitch ass pussy.
Yeah, I don't know what to do at this point. Every time he leaves me in charge, my immediate instinct is like, okay, talk about comic books. We're not going to talk about comic books.
Let's talk about the values and benefits of the 45 ACP round over the 9mm round.
Okay, no, because if we start talking about guns, you're the only one that really knows that much about it.
No way, that's a good topic. Well, okay, all right, we'll do that. We'll do that on the blunt stream. Dongwave, come on the blunt stream. We'll talk about guns on Thursday. Yeah, that'll be fine.
Although I do have to ask, AP, what kind of gun do you have?
I have a Remington 870 at the ready right fucking now, and I have a 45 long Colt that is ready to intimidate and make a motherfucker shit his pants before I ever have to fucking pull the trigger. That's what I have. Also, I have a Colt 1911 ready to come out of the fucking closet, have the clip put in, and put many bullets into Scooby if he comes to the door. Yes, sir.
Oh, you said 1911. That's my favorite. That's my favorite.
I also have a 1911. US
Army, it was good enough for me, sir.
Oh man, I love the 1911. When it comes to revolvers,
how great is the 1911, man? It's the perfect I will go this far. The 1911 is the perfect semi-automatic handgun design, and everything since then has been a mistake.
It's been based on the design of the 1911.
Pretty much.
But if you base something on the design of the 1911, you're altering the design of the 1911, which is a mistake.
Well, that's why I said based on. Oh, look, we've got Frazier. A motherfucker from we got somebody from Gannon's crew over here. What's up, man?
Hey.
You got some Scooby stories to tell?
Dude, I do got some Scooby stories to tell, man. Hell yeah. See, my mom, she's a big of a drug addict, dude. So she would sit there and watch old Scooby-Doo episodes while she got a eye on her pills.
Shut your goddamn mouth. We're talking about a different fucking Scooby. You knew that, Frazier.
Fuck all y'all. Tom P, what's up, man? Tell us.
What is going on, my brothers? How the fuck y'all doing tonight?
Chilling, making fun of Scooby, man. And you know Tom P's going to start the sentence with, now here's the situation. That's how you know shit just got real.
look. Here's what had happened, all right? fucking Scooby. I sat and I watched 6 hours worth of fucking Scooby goddamn fucking live streams a day. All right. To find out that all of his fucking friends are telling him that he did nothing wrong and that he should continue to fucking come at us because he wants to clear his good name. And that's why all this shit is happening.
He had cleared his good name
by embarrassing himself further.
Yes.
Fuck's sake, Scooby. I said your brother was disappointed in you. Now he's gonna put you the fuck down.
Man, this motherfucker is just like a woman.
The fucking cats that come out retarded.
He's like a woman or a liberal.
She should have dragged your body down to the fucking lake and put your head under for a couple minutes.
Like she did to your daddy.
That's where your daddy's really gone.
Yeah, that's when your daddy probably killed himself because he got tired of fucking looking at you, Scooby. What you got to say? If you have any kind of man, why don't you come defend your bloodline, dude? Why don't you come out here and defend your fucking family? Your fucking dad don't respect you.
Wait. Maybe he isn't a real man. Scooby, if you're willing, you pop on here, and afterwards, I'll show you my balls. I'll wiggle them around
shape
for
like
you.
A fat woman. Let's be honest.
Damn, you can take a look at some testicles. It'll be the most intimate thing you've had since your mom gave you a kiss this morning.
He doesn't know he ain't coming on here.
No,
he's a little bitch. We know he's not going to show up.
He's not going to show up to have, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 dudes.
I will kick every one of you out if Scooby will pop on.
Yeah, I'll mute myself.
It will be just me and Dong Waves necessary. And AP and Scooby can bring whatever the fuck friends he wants.
Does he? What if he doesn't have any friends?
He doesn't have any friends. But that don't matter.
I tried being nice to the dude. I was like, dude, look, just leave us the fuck alone. Nobody's worried about you. Nobody wants to talk about you. Nobody wants to discuss anything about you. We don't give a fuck what you do. Just leave us be and go on about your fucking business. Stop sending us links to the fucking FBI every 3 or 4 fucking days. For fuck's sake.
That could go double for a certain roach.
Yeah, no, some hardcore paisan, right? He's gonna say he's narking you out to the feds. Some fucking Italian he is, man. I'm connected. I'm a real paisan. By the way, I'm talking to the feds. Thanks, Henry Hill.
That's one of the things that gets me. He's in with the mob and he's in with the FBI. What the fuck does that make
and
him?
And a biker gang.
You know what that makes? That makes him a fucking
and
metagon.
Hollywood agents.
I'm saying he makes him a fucking piece of shit. That's what the fuck, a piece of dog. That's literally what the fuck it makes him. Worthless ass, good for nothing.
It makes him at the very least somebody who, if the mob were to hear of him, he'd be fucking dead.
I got something to say.
If he was really wrapped up with the mob and he's also really wrapped up with the FBI, that's probably something he shouldn't be doing.
Scooby, I don't know you. I don't know you at all. I don't know anything about Scooby. But I definitely want to get about 2 knuckles deep in that ass. So you come on here. Make that happen.
That's right, man. Ganon's Royal Guard is waiting for you.
Yeah, I'm saying, like, me and Irate have been talking about this shit for fucking weeks now. You know what I'm saying? Because he's been going on and on and on, sending us messages, threatening us with the fucking FBI, saying he's going to come after everybody, all this fucking dumbass bullshit for weeks now. You know what I'm saying? And then all of a sudden, he's sending me a message from fucking AP. He's like, oh, here, deliver this to your boy AP, you fucking piece of shit or whatever. And he fucking talking about skinning his fucking dick, skin or some fucking retarded ass nonsense. His skin flute to fucking Weebo Jones or some retarded ass bulls. Yo, Scooby's a fucking bag, dude. Like, I don't know. Like, why can't he just shut the fuck up and leave everybody the fuck alone?
Because that nigga is so internally gay, he thinks calling someone straight is an insult. You want to fuck Weebo Jones. That's not really true, but even if it was, that ain't no insult. She's a cute chick. Now, trying to fuck that bitch, what's her name, Terrison? That would be an insult.
And yeah, that would be a mean thing to say.
A buck tooth fat bitch.
You by the way, Brockus, it's on a been video a while for you. It's been a while, Brockus. What do you think about
Tara? This bitch can suck dick through a picket fence, man, with those the fucking gap in her teeth, man.
Yeah, I told her last time I seen her, she flosses with a fucking mic cord. Like, yo. I ran her the fuck off the cunt stream here like fucking a couple months ago when they were doing their fundraiser and shit.
Was that her and that other dude who didn't want to get a job? Was that him?
No. I don't think Tara had anything to do with Ron. I think that was someone else.
No, it was the anti-hero joint.
Anti.
Yeah, when they were raising money for Anti-Hero.
Raise money for... Oh, okay.
Yeah, we did. You weren't around because I think you either had IRL obligations or you were sick.
Oh, was this when I was in New Brunswick?
Yeah, you and your family went somewhere or some bullshit. So you went on
I was visiting family. It was New Brunswick.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
I would like to thank everybody for the death threats that I received tonight for tonight's show that I absolutely did request. Some of you have been kind enough to follow up on the death threats. And I appreciate that. Let's see. I got one says, I'm not going to say who it's from because they're all awesome fucking people. They sent me a picture of somebody's been mutilated in a bed and said, this is how we'll kill you, AP. Marianne Kelly, Jack the Ripper. Oh, shit. Well, yeah, now I know a little bit of history. Thank you very much for that threat. Zero Cool cannot be rude to me, unfortunately. Thank you, though, Zero Cool. And
One second, AP. We got the bitching witch saying Scooby's FBI bullshit is the internet version of my dad's in the CIA, and you better be nice to me or he'll get you in trouble. No,
let's be real honest. This same. Is the equivalent
the of police are after you.
This is the equivalent of my dad works for Microsoft and he'll get you banned from Call of Duty.
Right. Jesus. I just realized my beer's out. Leaf's in charge. I'll be back.
What?
Is Leaf here?
That's not what I wanted, but okay. I literally just
thought. Fuck you. I don't care what you want. You're in charge. I'll be back.
Oh, man. You're too young for me to sexualize, but please tell us.
We aren't supposed to be in charge. What is this?
Tell us about Scooby. Tell us about your experiences with Scooby 331 Leaf and how bitch made he is.
Scooby very recently made a very vague threat through someone else, but directed at me. He implied he either wants to send a scary chainsaw man to kill me or to abduct me and force me into prostitution. I'm still not quite sure about that one.
And this is the nigga calling the FBI on people. Please, Scooby, please call him. Because, you know, the only thing that would get me to make a case over internet bullshit would be if you tried that shit. And I think we have plenty of evidence to put your ass behind bars, dude.
Go buy a chainsaw. Keep the receipt.
Just lay that shit down.
Listen. But if he did send a big scary chainsaw man to my house to try to kill me, all I would need to do is grab a black guy off the street and the chainsaw man would just automatically be drawn towards him like a fucking magnet and then I'd get away.
Now you insinuating that you don't already have a black guy in your house.
Provided that he hadn't killed anybody else yet, yes, the black guy's the first one to go in a horror movie. You're correct.
Leaf keeps a black guy around so she can fuck him in front of Kumara. You know what I'm saying? Kumara can wax it off in the fucking...
What if the black guy's a virgin? Does he die first?
I don't know, but Tom P, you remember this nigga had dick socks, man. He had dick socks on his Amazon list and dildos and shit, man. You remember all that nonsense.
That fucking shit is dumb, man. Like, yo, why the fuck is Scooby still talking to us? Like, yo, why is Scooby still fucking
around at this point? Like, hasn't he gotten the fucking message? An autistic suicide? Get the fucking message at this point.
Yo, I sent him two really nice messages. Just like, yo, bro, come on, dude. Seriously, like, yo, you motherfucker, yo, me and you was cool. We was tight. You know what I'm saying? Like, just take your ass and fucking go somewhere for a little bit and then come back and build and do your own thing, make some content, and then come back and apologize for all the shit you did. And like, yo, you can move on with your life and grow and become a better person. And he sat here and said, fuck you, clown. I can't wait to take you all down. Fucking here's the FBI number. Call and find out about your case.
We should call that number and find out about our case. And then every piece of information they need to go kick door that motherfucker's mama's
yo, it is, yo, it is the number of the FBI in fucking Long Island. In Long Island.
That's interesting that they has the same last name as the goddamn FBI agent, but whatever, that's cool.
Yeah, it is weird that the FBI agent's his brother. Like, that is odd to me, but you know, sometimes people have similar names, I guess.
Come on, come at me with everything you got, Scooby. Come at me with everything you got, man. I guarantee your ass is gonna have a backfire on you. It's already done so today in a minor way with the internet, but I would love to death if you tried to get law enforcement involved and I got to fucking give all this shit over to law enforcement. Be like, as you can see, he's messaged me 119 times and I haven't fucking messaged him back once. So But yeah, now that you're here, I would like to make a fucking, I would like to make a report for harassment now that you can see it's legitimate. I would like to do that. Also, here's the threats in writing that he's given me. Also, here's the threats he's given other everybody else and their contact information to contact them to verify it. I will not be put in cuffs, Scooby. Guarantee. And also, if you think the FBI is worried about your bitch ass getting called a faggot on the internet, you got another thing coming, man. They got real shit. These are the people that hunted down Osama bin Laden. But you're gonna fucking come. You gonna come at me?
They actually were not the people who hunted down Osama bin Laden.
Okay, well they had the list that Osama bin Laden was on the top of. You know what I mean? And then the military went and found his ass in Pakistan.
Oh, but
I just want to ask. Well, one second, Pinoy. We got irate prostate here. Before we go into shit, before we go into that shit, I want to ask Leith. You were the one that, the reason we first became aware of you was because of the Scooby shit. Give us a refresher on what that was.
He was trying to act like Mr. Internet tough guy, and he's making all threats and doxing people, hiding behind a neo-Nazi LARPer. So I wasn't the one doxing you guys. See, it was my pal Mickey Coy. He's did it. Just his little mouthpiece. I'm just I'm trying to help him. No, that's not what you're doing, Scooby.
Are you still like going off your phone or something? Because you're cutting out like real bad.
I will move to a better area so the connection's not as too much about my current situation right now.
Let's see, you really should just beat up your aunt so that you prove that you're the alpha in the situation, and then you'd have control over the internet. You're doing everything really wrong. I know at least Pinoid will agree with me.
Dude, she can beat up the biggest, baddest dude in the fucking goddamn yard, and no one is going to fucking follow her.
Yeah, exactly.
This bitch ain't shit. With that nonsense, this bitch ain't shit. Quit it. Stop gassing her up.
I'm trying to give her some confidence.
You see in this Pinoy how these niggas want to just be gassing a bitch up for just having a vagina, man. You beat up anybody you want. You're going to get this bitch killed out on the street one of these days. She's going to buy into some of this shit. She's going to try to fight
it. I'm not saying she can beat up anyone she wants. I'm saying she can beat up her elderly, similarly sized aunt.
Guys, I am not Andy Worski. I don't just believe that I can do something just because I have people in my ear telling me.
Don't bring Andy into this. Andy's a good boy.
Oh, Andy's a good boy. Andy Worski, my best friend, my best bro, my closest confidant, is a piece of shit.
Schmeckle. Come on now. We aren't out here to talk about Andy. Leave that shit to the Tonka tribe. Leave that shit to the tribe, man. We're here to talk about
Tonka. I'm part of the Tonka tribe. Fuck Tonka too.
Apparently, according to Scooby, I'm a high-ranking member in the Donga tribe. So allow me to be the voice of... Let's stick to the fucking topic, man. I've gone way out of my way not to get involved in that fucking bullshit. I'm not trying to fucking start now. All right,
so fuck Andy, fuck Tonka. Let's get back to Scooby.
As long as the fuckings are equal, I can accept that. Irate Prostate, you've been threatened multiple times, and you're still here and alive. Why don't you tell your story about Scooby?
Yeah, he tried to put two in the back of my head, and I just went bada-bing, bada-bang, and I was done. You know what I'm saying?
What, he's got Hillary Clinton working for him now?
You have way too much of a southern accent to do that.
Remember when Scooby claimed that he got shot in the back of the head? I remember.
Yes, he was shot in the back of the fucking head, and I thought it explained a bunch of things. But shouldn't he be a lot more brain damaged if he was
shot? Well, let me tell you how that happened, Schmeckle. Let me tell you how that gunshot happened, all right? His daddy had only one bullet, and he looked at his son and was like,
he was like, me or you, me or you.
Because his family was so poor that he only had one bullet. So he was like, son, I'm going to get on my knees. I need you to stand right behind me. And he put the gun, it killed his dad. But unfortunately, his dad was able to kill himself. But unfortunately, the bullet just lodged itself.
He only brain damaged the son. Yeah.
He used a 9mm, so it just kind of bounced around his dad's head.
That's why he wears the mask. So he can cover the scar.
I need to know. Why are you not ignoring this fucking idiot?
Oh, why are we not ignoring this fucking idiot? We have been.
What are you talking about?
Check this out. Fucking, I blocked him. You know what he did? He went to Excel. My fucking, the guy who does all my production shit, he went to him and started threatening him to get to me.
That's another thing that confuses the fuck out of me about this whole thing. We exposed him for the fucking retard he is on Cunt Stream, and it was continued to be exposed on the Blunt Stream, and he turns around and threatens and fucking shits all over Irate Prostate and Atem of the Hun, two of his co-hosts who consistently stood up for him in both fucking cases, still decided that he's gonna threaten docs to both of them,
asked why we don't ignore him, because I'm about to show you something, and I'm about to break my own rule and screen share Discord.
It's me, Daddy-O, it's me.
Can I share one thing?
I don't have my eyes on that screen, so I'm sorry. It was no disrespect meant by not knowing exactly who you are. Let me show you something. I'm going to screen share something right now.
All
right,
bro.
You're asking why I don't ignore him? Look at all these messages. Do you see any messages back from me?
Jesus.
That's how obsessive this crazy motherfucker is.
Can you tell us how many?
119 that I counted, sir. 119 unanswered messages to fucking Scooby's obsessive ass. I'm gonna start thinking he wants to fuck me pretty soon. You know what I mean?
Check it out. And here's what he's doing. He sends you a sentence and then blocks you. And then he unblocks it, sends you another sentence, and then blocks you.
Right. Yeah.
He unblocks it, sends you another sentence, and then blocks you.
He wants to box AP, but he sent that
300 times. Think about that.
Yeah, look, I'll pull it back up again, so I'll do it live where I accept his challenge for a boxing match.
Do it up.
Quite frankly, he'll never see it because he has me blocked. He's like, what a little bitch. All right, we'll go back to that.
Funny, man. This is fucked up
over here.
Crazy motherfucker.
Yeah, let me go back to screen share here. All right, so check this. So check it out, man. Like, you're seeing this right here. Watch this. I accept your bitch ass challenge to box, you fat motherfucker. Oh, look, I'm blocked. That he's throwing out here.
Oh, well, when I tried to invite him, I was blocked. Brocka says he's blocked.
Yep.
Dongwave was able to get a message through because he didn't know who Dongwave was.
I'm blocked.
Actually, that's not entirely true. Apparently, he does know who I am because he's a huge fan of Naked Ape.
Okay, then he's just never had any issue with Dongwave.
Said he's got no beef with me, so.
Well, then tell him to show the fuck up, say do it as a favor to me and Naked Ape.
Scooby's friends with
does
Naked Ape.
Does he realize that he's...
If you show up, Naked Ape will like you.
I really am surprised to hear that Naked Ape would associate with a piece of shit like that.
I don't think they associate. I just think he likes Apes videos.
Jacob Nabo is a fan of us, and I hate that motherfucker.
I mean, Ape associates with me.
You are 1,000 times the man that fucking Scooby 331.
Hey, you don't know me. Look, I'm about to start.
I know enough about you to know you're... You know how you're talking to me right now? And that makes you 1,000 times the man he is.
Hey, maybe I'm not talking to you.
Anti-hero
just responded to me.
Don't think he has his... he doesn't think Scooby has him blocked. Anti-hero, it doesn't matter. We did get him. We did get a link through to him. He's too much of a bitch to show up.
Does anybody know National Libertarian?
No.
No.
Nationalist Libertarian, yeah, man.
Yeah, he actually, some shit he shows up money, in my man. Chat sometimes. Yeah, he's okay.
He says we're all pieces of shit too. Because
that's right, man. He was jacking that motherfucker off like I mean, Jesus Christ.
That's funny. He comes into my chat. He doesn't start shit ever. So I mean, yeah,
he was here. He was here in the beginning of the, like on the fucking when the stream was announced. I hope he's still here and listening to what the fuck he's being told. You know what I mean? Because, like, legit, we try to just leave this piece of shit alone. Nobody wants to have to continue to deal with this retarded-ass fucking nonsense over and over again. Nobody.
Hey, AP, I want to turn off presentation, because otherwise only you show up on screen and people can't tell who the fuck's talking.
I'm the one that has to end.
All right, can I make one point, and I want to make it really strong and clearly, all right? Right after the shit happened for the second time, all right, somebody hit me up on Twitter and DMs and said, look, if you need Scooby's address, telephone number, and name, I can provide you for that. And then I said, what, you want me to dox him? And they said, no, to give it to the, you know, the authorities if they need it. And I said, no, thanks. I'm not a fucking doxer.
Right.
I've got screen caps to prove that shit.
When Tom contacted me, I took that information in a hot second. I was like, yeah, give me that shit.
Nah, man.
When it comes to that, it's not doxing. Doxing means you'd have to spread it publicly with a malicious intent.
Yeah, I haven't said his name.
You're talking legal terms and shit like that. I think as far as doxing goes, though, we can all agree it's when you you search for and post the shit.
When you spread that shit around, you then became a fucking doxer. Until then, yeah, you were just a curious fucking party. And you know what? When somebody contacted me and they were like, do you want Scooby's fucking information to make sure that if somebody comes after you legally, you have a recourse? So yeah, give me everything you got. And I did. And they gave me the information for his fucking crew, too. And his fucking little bitch. And none of you have fucking heard it. So there goes that whole AP's gonna fucking dox us shit.
Why are you going after his little bitch?
AP actually told me all this shit on air. I know all of the details of Scooby.
Little bitch didn't do nothing.
Scooby wants to send everybody else after.
And after it was sent to him, he just handed it straight. Fucking damn it, Shrekle. I'm sorry, I was just going on with some nonsense about AP being a dog, so you go on.
I'm going to punch you in the way. Anyways, as I was trying to say, this is
single. Get yourself a stepping stool and punch me in the face, Leaf.
Anyways, no. So Scooby likes to say he'll so-and-so after you. That's what he does. He never says, I'm going to come and do this thing. Want to know why? Because Scooby walks with a fucking cane and he's fat as hell. He can't do anything on his own, so he has to get everyone for him.
I don't know if I believe that. Tonk is in a wheelchair, apparently, right? So I don't know.
Yeah, but Scooby has admitted that he needs a cane. That's a different thing.
There's video of him on Terra Sin's fucking channel walking around at a MAGA rally with a fucking cane that anyone can go watch right fucking now and see what kind of worthless piece of shit you're being threatened by.
I started watching that and then I saw Terra's face and I noped the fuck out of that because I wanted to sleep peacefully and not have nightmares for the rest
of my
life.
That bitch is ugly though, man. Even when she fucking tries to distort her face and shit, you can still see that big ass fucking mole on the left side of her cheek. And you know what, Burnside? Yeah, I'm talking about your bitch. You know why? Because if you will associate with Scooby and this fucking bitch, you are just as fucking bad. If you're gonna be out here fucking defending Scooby, if your bitch is the one calling me, contacting me, DMing me all fucking day, talking about fucking please leave Scooby alone, all that fucking shit, then you can put a muzzle on that hoe because you know better. Especially if you're in a fucking MC and this guy's out here making threats via you. You should fucking know better. You should hate this motherfucker because he's going to get you and your MC in a whole fucking lot of trouble if he did call the FBI.
But never mind that whole lot of trouble. I'm sitting here on the con stream. I get overwhelmed by somebody and I say, well, yeah, AP's going to rip you a new one. That's fucking weak, right?
Unless it's Scooby, you fully have my authorization to tell him that I will rip him a new asshole.
But no, I mean, I'm sitting there getting beat up by somebody verbally. And I'm like, yeah, well, this guy's going to get you.
Oh, yeah, that would make you a bitch-ass nigga.
That's a bitch fucking move, right?
Yo, can somebody invite Excel, man, my fucking my partner and shit. You got some shit to say about this?
That's cool. I'll dip out, dudes. Thanks for letting
no,
me.
No, that's cool.
You dumb motherfucker. Count to 10.
Yeah, there's. Oh. I just didn't send the invite link because I'm on my fucking phone.
Jesus Christ! Nobody on the internet can count to 10.
Yeah, hold on, I'm on it.
I like the chew star that you put in my hand up there. Yeah,
I'm giving you a Nazi armband too.
Now, cool. Tom, what was that you said about Terra when they did the telethon thing for National Hero?
Oh yeah, I told him she flosses this with a fucking mic cord.
And what about her tits? What did you say about her tits?
I said the milk gone sour. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Bitch is fucked up. Hey, I just want to say, I want to throw a shout out to Donka Show in the chat, man. Donka, he made heap big insult to the white man. So I must come. We go to kill evil men. We probably all die. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm speaking in ancient Native American dialect to my man Donka Show out there. It's good to see you.
Oh.
Most heap best Donka Troll, man. That's the shit. I like that guy.
I'm glad it switched to Donka instead of Donga. Because I always confused whether they were talking about Tonka or Dong.
can only wish that after this fight, man, Donka Show becomes like whatever a fucking amalgamation of my name is, because I would love to get that kind of fucking trolling, dude. That guy's hilarious.
Day P. Like that's
becomes Day P, dude. Just so I can fucking I'll go back and forth on the internet and be like, dude, let's fuck, dude. Gay P, dude. It's like a match made in heaven. I love that shit.
I could see that being fun. I'd watch it.
I'd super chat that stream.
On slow motion, muted. It'd be a fun time. But no, I wanted to hear a little bit more about Leaf. He still here?
I'm still here.
Your shit with him is kind of what I think it's what made me aware of you. I had known Scooby for a small time beforehand. But it's what brought Scooby being ridiculous out into the light. GCV's been mentioned a bunch of times. I know you introduced me to him. Can you explain a little bit more their particular beef?
I met Scooby through GCV, and they seemed chill. Like, GCV invited me to a stream that was Scooby, G, fucking, I think, Burner, and other people I can't remember, honestly. And a bit odd. Like, funny,
I realized, Leaf, if I'm going to ask you to keep talking things, you're going to need to get closer to a source of internet.
Yo, their whole stream, like, legitimately, like, it all started off with a bunch of delusional ass motherfuckers home. Like, I was watching the stream last night, and the person who started Chaos 120, like, they said that they lived inside of, like, a fucking myth.
You know, I want to yell at the boy.
Wait. The person who started the Chaos 120 show no longer wants anything to do with the Chaos 120 show. She gave it away.
Who was it? This time?
Yes, her. She said, like, either her or somebody else said fucking they live inside of a missile silo, a decommissioned nuclear missile silo.
Probably wasn't who you're thinking of.
Who started it and who was involved with Chaos? I know there was
I can't remember her Twitter handle. Sylviana something. She started the Chaos 120 show. Because of Scooby and all them and all their autism, she actually left her own show that she started. She's like, nah, fuck this. You guys can have it. I'm out. Imagine being so autistic you drive the original person who made it away.
Yeah, and they all just sit there and fuck each other.
And imagine being Brockus.
But no, this whole thing with Scooby started, well, for me anyway, started back in February of last year, because he didn't get to sit at the cool kids table. He was mad because he didn't get on.
He wasn't invited to your birthday stream. He actually got mad because he was not invited to her birthday party.
Yeah, well, I'm pretty sure him not being invited is the entire reason behind all of Scooby's rage. Like, seriously, I'm fucking getting shit from Scooby. Sorry, I just joined.
I'm sorry, Scooby has been invited tonight. He's turned down my invitation. I'm angry now.
Funny enough, earlier I was told
you come to my birthday party, Scooby?
You wanted me to unblock him and talk to him about all this fucking crazy shit that's going on. But the thing is, the only reason I'm not going to unblock him is because he's fucking crazy. Like, none of this shit happened. Like, Tom P, did you do you know Scooby's mom's phone number?
No.
Coincidentally, but only because she gave it to me.
I know, right?
it wasn't a doxing thing. It was random hookup thing. It's mom's kind of a slut.
FBI agent Ramirez, he's got all the information wrong. You just like towed the key. It wasn't Tom P. It was Schmeckle all along.
This whole time, yeah, I've had your mother's number, but it's because she handed it to me. We met in a bar one time. She was, I wouldn't say hot, but certainly drunk.
Tom P's doxing people. Like, Tom P's a fucking Luddite, dude. He would not have fucking doxed somebody if he wanted to.
To be fair, Tom P, to be fair, Scooby, I don't know if it's actually your mom's number. I've never called her back. It could have been a fake.
Is it a one-line number?
The funniest thing, though, is Scooby has repeatedly said he's scared of me.
Don't fuck around with Scooby's
because
mom,
you're fucking terrifying, Lee.
If you fuck Scooby's mom, you're going to end up fucking killing yourself like his dad did.
Get this.
I once sat in a conversation with Leaf and her boyfriend and laughed while unsavory things and not sexual things, but unsavory things happened.
I was listening to him talk about
Leaf, I was nice there. I didn't say he cried.
Schmeckle, wait. You didn't let me finish saying why Scooby is scared of me. Scooby said he's scared of me. Because I once said I want to kill the pedophiles, and by killing the pedophiles, I mean I want pedophiles to be lined up in front of a fucking firing squad. And he said,
"Wait, he's afraid of people that want to kill pedophiles." I just got to ask him. Well, one second, we got a bunch of people here that ain't Leaf. I'll go down the list. AP, I want to kill pedophiles. You scared of me?
No, because I'm not a fucking pedophile.
Brockus, I want to kill pedophiles. You scared of me?
No, I want to join you.
Dongwave, I want to kill pedophiles. You scared of me?
Can I help?
I think Dongwave's
is there a gun?
Excel, apparently
Dongwave might be able to use
in this endeavor.
et cetera and so forth. The rest of you, I want to kill pedophiles. You scared of me?
What about Scooby, the friendly pedophile?
Yeah, no, dude. I'll
but Scooby's a virtuous pedophile, you guys. He's a non-active pedophile.
I'm not
maybe,
like...
Maybe that extra small dick sock... maybe that extra small...
It wasn't for him.
All right, y'all. I'm gonna slide, okay? I'll see y'all later.
Have a good one, Irene. I hope you're not leaving because you're angry that we're saying mean things about pedophiles.
No, but he doesn't want to get involved in falsely accusing somebody of being a pedophile, he's, even as a joke. Something we all shouldn't be engaging in, to be honest.
I'm not accusing him of anything. I'm just saying it's an easy answer. Does somebody wanting to kill pedophiles make you afraid?
I was talking about Hanna-Barbera's beloved character, Scooby-Doo.
Oh, well, no. If Scooby-Doo were into kids, I'd be fine with it.
I don't know.
He's a dog. It's fine. He only gets to be like 14-year-old. He
that
only
seems
gets
like
to be
14 more of a
years
Scrappy
old.
Doo kind of thing.
That's why he has Scrappy Doo hanging around with him so much, man.
Oof! 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 The deep lore.
Is that Mickey's alter ego?
God, fucking Mickey Coy was just like step one, right? All they did was export the user list of the Cuntstream Discord. And say, you guys better watch out. Like, I was on the list, and I was like, what the fuck did I do?
Yo, I wasn't even on the list.
They pulled a list of the Cunstream Discord? When was
yep,
that?
That's all it was. Yeah, Mickey Coy.
Well, they also got some, accounts for people, like social media accounts, and that was about it. And two people had their personal information sent to them, but beyond that, they didn't. Really do anything.
Leaf, you are very lucky to be invited into the teepee and the bed of the Donka Show. I suggest you take him up on that shit.
Sure.
He smoked him on peace pipe. Give you the big dick.
I do have to be honest, though, Leaf. His name sounds like Tonka, which means he's probably close to Tonka. He's probably better than Mara.
Why do you have to fucking talk shit about Mara, man? Okay. I was making a joke.
Why do can I talk you... shit on Mara? Because I don't like Mara.
All right, fair enough. That's your business.
See,
Leaf, well, I'm going to get off here, guys.
Later.
It's late where I am, and I do have a job now.
Before
so
you go, AP, is that Colt you mentioned a Series 70 or a Series 80?
I don't know.
Because if it's a Series 80, you should get a Ruger instead.
I do not know. I know I purchased it from a gentleman that works at a gun shop. Or from a dude who works as a gunsmith at a relatively well-known shop. I've never really looked into it other than know I had a badass fucking revolver.
He doesn't know about guns. He just knows if you
not
point
the revolver,
and pull the trigger, kill the guy.
You said you had a 1911. Is it a Series 70 or Series 80?
He already left, man.
Nah. Series 80 is bad, folks.
It was just as uninteresting to him as it was to the rest of us.
Yeah, I really don't care about your gun thing. Right, yo, he went to my Facebook and stole one of my pictures with me with no shirt on off my Facebook.
Or was it a good
why
picture?
Why did he only take that picture?
Yeah, no, it was pretty good.
No, wait, Pinoy.
They overlaid it with the picture. Bikini.
Was it attractive? Yeah, were you in shape?
No, not at all. It was after I was driving truck, so I was not in shape.
But, so you had a big ass gut, and he figured, hey, I can use this to rip into the guy.
Yeah, and then like as he was a manager on my backup YouTube channel, and he took it, he put that picture up with like me in like a bathing suit, and then deleted all my fucking content off my fucking YouTube joint.
He deleted all your shit.
Yeah,
okay. Yeah, it really wasn't that big of a deal, but it's it's Scooby trying to flex his weight, right? Oh, I hacked your alternate channel, and that was like,
man, why the fuck did you think it was a good idea to trust that guy?
They deleted all of his videos and changed the picture. And Tom Pinoy was like, well, I'll just delete this fucking brand channel, but still, like. He thought that was like worth his time to go through and delete every single video on that channel that had what was the max views on the bubble? Maybe like 20 views.
No. It was like one with like 300 from the funeral for Steven.
Oh, Biden. Yeah. You had that one. Yeah. Cause irate. Yeah. That would have been a good one to keep, man. That guy's just a fucking asshole.
Yeah. So explain to me what you were just fucking messaging me about. What the fuck did they say about you?
Oh, yeah, like Scooby was talking about how, like, he's going to break my fucking legs for talking so much shit on him and all that.
More fucking leg breaking.
Yeah, like, all I did was, I don't usually do it, but it was on my gaming stream, and I'm talking to Sinrise, and I was like, this Scooby motherfucker just keeps sending me, like, bullshit. Like, I don't understand what's going on. Like, he's going to report me to the like, what the fuck did I do? Like, my work requires a very extensive background check, and I'm not going to, like, go too far into dox myself, but I guarantee, yeah, Scooby could find my first and last name and where I live, but nonetheless, the FBI would investigate me and be like, this man did nothing wrong. What is your problem? But, some
things about me on the internet.
Yeah. I wasn't even the fucking worst of all of them. Like, after all that shit with GCV went down, I was just like, whatever, man, I don't care, right? I'm not going to be a part of it. And I still talked to him a little bit, but then he just, like, kept fucking diving deeper, like, bringing up a bigger hole for himself. And I'm just like, all right, can't talk to this guy anymore. And as soon as that happened, all of a sudden he was like, you're blacklisted too. Like, all this is like a fucking childish rage. Right, like, oh, these are people on the internet that used to talk to me, and they won't talk to me anymore, and I'm mad because they won't talk to me anymore. That's all it is, right? Like, I'm nobody, but that's what this really boils down to.
Yeah.
Well, I think we can come to a pretty simple conclusion here. Scooby was born without a sack. Like, he's one of those weird, like, XXY situations where he's got neither set of genitals. He doesn't have the
if he had
strength of a woman or the testicular fortitude of a man. He's
I mean here's the bitch. It sounds
he's not even a pussy. He's more like a jellyfish.
And 70 fucking pounds. Excel will fucking smash almost anybody. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, like, Excel ain't a bitch. He's doxed himself a many fucking times. But
I don't overtly try to dox myself, but, like, I, like, my, anybody here, yo, if you want to know who I am, where I live, and what I do, do enough research. You'll find it out. It's not that hard.
Excel, you trying to say you're going to smash with anybody?
Yep.
Excel's a beast. You know, I mean, get up the misunderstood. Like, I'm not running around with fucking chumps. But, like, fuck Scooby, home. Like, for fuck's sake, your issues with me, AP, Irate, and fucking whoever. Nigga, yo, focus on me. You know what I'm saying? Bring your shit my way. Leave my motherfucking team out of it.
Like, in a way, this guy, but, like, he's a bitch, dude. Like, he can't do that. Like, he's got a fucking, like, he's reaching out to Timma about, like, IRS fucking bullshit fraud. It was like, that's fucking batshit crazy, and I never did it, and at this point, you might actually be legally harassing me, so you should check yourself before you wreck yourself, which is very true. And by the way, I really hope he keeps bothering the FBI, because all he did is like that phone number he gave everybody, right? Like, look up that phone number. The first thing that comes up, Long Island FBI office. Like, it's a public fucking phone number. Anybody can call that. I hope he keeps calling it before the FBI shows up to his house and is like, yeah, you're fucking crazy. We need to do an evaluation on you.
That was one of the big things. He sent that link out, hoping for people to reach a certain officer or a certain FBI guy, right?
I have no doubt you'd have an extension. Yeah, yeah. I have no doubt he called that number, asked for the person's name, and that's who he's giving us, right? He called that number because he's so – but the FBI themselves is like, yeah, they have a number. You can call it. Call that number. Just, like, say random shit, talk all crazy. They'll tell you – like, they'll give you a name and fucking – oh, yeah, if you need to call back, call the standard number that anybody can call by looking up the FBI office number.
The man in the hat's got my balls. Excel's been talking to the walls, man. I can't stop. Oh.
Well, no, and that's exactly the thing. Like, he didn't even provide an extension or anything like that. He just provided a number that anybody could Google.
And the name, which actually is probably the last name of the person that he called when they asked his their last name, and they're like, I'm so-and-so, and then he's like, yeah, just ask for whatever.
Exactly. He picked the first fucking person he spoke to, right? If he had actually been in touch with this person, and they were like, yeah, get these people in touch with me, he'd have an extension.
In reality, so first off, like, any complaints he has, unless it's these batshit things about tax fraud with Atima, but like just like a random threat, like even you go to the site that he links you to, like with a fact, they're like, if you're getting threats from people over the internet, please call local law enforcement. It's not even the FBI's jurisdiction.
Well, yeah, and that's
fucking asshole.
That's another thing. It's not an FBI issue. With the things that have been said about him, it's not even a law enforcement issue. It's a completely frivolous accusation.
As an expert in soundboard prank phone calls, I can tell you that the law enforcement are almost toothless in almost every regard when it comes
thing. There's no reason for them to fucking deal with this.
That's what I'm saying. It's like
the vast majority of the shit that's been said about him has been entirely true and open to mockery because of how fucking ridiculous it is. There is a point. I forget the name of the fucking thing that makes it legal. But there is a point where it becomes... there's a term that describes something that's mockable to the point where, yeah, say whatever the fuck you want about this.
Is that the law regarding your penis?
No, it came up in one of the cases involving Scientology, actually.
Oh, wow.
This thing is so easily mockable. It's such an easy source of comedy that we can't blame people for going after it.
Basically. Have any of you guys ever been to Clearwater or Dunedin in Florida?
No.
Dude, those motherfuckers in the Scientology, they run around that bitch like constantly. Like, they're just walking everywhere. You drive down like US 19, I swear to God, there's nothing but signs up for DirecTV's Scientology channel. And it's just like, this is where the real action is. But you go down to this Clearwater, you walk around a Main Street, there's these guys in these button down white t-shirts and these black pants, and every one of them is part of the Scientology church down there.
We almost had a Scientology church built near us, but people were so against it that it never ended up happening.
I don't think you can stop a church from being built.
Yeah, there were petitions and protests against them because they wanted to change parts of the land and stuff. They ended up not being able to use the land the way they wanted to. Nobody wanted fucking Scientologists in the area.
They're a bona fide cult.
No, we still do have them. They just don't have, like, the Like they wanted basically an area for I guess like what do you call it? Like the area cults confined to. And we ended up
compound.
A compound.
And finish yeah. Megma.
And
yo, well, we ended you're up in charge, my nigga.
Bob Hill comment.
we gave them an apartment building instead. So I think that's a little better than letting a cult move in and form a compound.
Cults are cool, man. Wish I ran one.
I'd love to run a cult. Any cult that I don't run, I'm opposed to.
Can we get Scooby to join?
By the way, Brockus, have you ever heard of the good Lord Schmeckle? He smiles down upon you, and one day he may release your chains and allow you to stand on 2 feet instead of 4.
Schmeckle, just a hint, my dude. You're supposed to be getting women. Unless you're trying to fuck Brockus, he's the wrong tree.
Oh, I'm trying to fuck Brockus as a warm-up.
Oh, man. Brockus, how do you feel about this? Stay silent if you want it.
He's so into it.
Dongwave, hey, what are you doing, dude? You,
I'm talking about guns in the chat with American Phoenix.
Oh, man. Tell American Phoenix that the only gun he should have is it's a bolt-action rifle because semi-automatics are for pussies.
Now, Leaf, I do have to ask. Obviously, yeah. You are with a very swell man who I have no negative feelings about by the name of Kamara. I know that you guys are living long distance. Do you think that it would be efficient for you guys to meet up again at a Schmeckle cult meetup?
That's never going to happen.
We'll have like multicolored tents with gorillas painted on them. Brockus will be the court jester. Brockus, say nothing if you agree.
Hey, if he wraps this all up into a business enterprise, it can become tax write-off.
There will be juggling. I'll get somebody who can juggle. You can watch the whole thing.
Is he going to be juggling your balls? I think Leaf left.
Yeah, she did. I brought up her sex life and she got upset.
Upsetty? Did you get some upsetty in her spaghetti? Dude, I think that the show is dead.
It might be, but I don't close down my own show, so it's going to have to wait till Brockus is back.
until then.
Yeah, you prep that shit up.
Prep the bull.
All right, I guess I can close this shit down myself. Tonight we had me, we had Dongwave, we had Brockus, we had AP, we had that Frasier motherfucker. The Leaf was here briefly. Irate Prostate, hate that guy. Excel, don't actually know who he is. And Brockus again.
Oh shit.
Oh, Brockus, shut down the stream.
How?
Actually, wait, I had an even better idea. Don't shut down the stream, invite Trippy on.
What? Why?
Send a link to Trippy.
Why?
Just do what you're told. Brockus. Thank you.
Also, Brockus, you're gay now.
Also, Dongwave, don't shut shit down yet.
I didn't.
Good.
You can hear the existential terror in his voice.
The chat's all sitting there like, later, guys. Have a good one. Good to see you guys. I mean, that's just a Tama. But I'm going to consider her the chat. She's a pretty substantial woman. She's very small. That wasn't a fat joke. I was just saying that she's noticeable and important.
Visible from 50 miles.
Bring Trippy on. And actually bring a Tama on.
I already sent her the link. She can't.
Oh, okay. Okay,
apparently,
Trippy says
you blocked Trippy, so he can't do
you
shit.
Blocked him. So unblock that motherfucker.
Gee, what an idea. Like,
oh,
I didn't
Brock has already figured it out. He figured it out all on his own. I'm so proud of him. Just because of that, Brockus, I'm going to go have a quick smoke. You're in charge.
Maybe he'll let you stand up on two legs sometime, I guess. Jesus Christ. This is a shit show, Dongwave.
Well, Yeah, it's the cunt stream. It's normal.
I forgot I already had the bong next to me.
Excuse me. Well, I've been removing hair from my chest the entire time we've been doing this with a machine with spinning tweezers on it. So,
Temma says, "Keep going, Schmeckle." LOL. Temma, why don't you get in here? We'll have great conversations. Your kids are being kids. Oh yeah, I can understand that.
Look at the dejection on Schmeckle's face right now.
I'm upset, Temma. I was hoping you'd be here.
He is dejected.
I was waiting for you. Yeah, you know my sexual preferences and fit right in. Anyway, one of you's in charge for the couple seconds while I do this. I have to mute.
My dude, that is definitely, like, that's a gun, right? You gonna put that in your face?
Yes, I'm about to blow my brains out.
Oh, shit, man. Oh, he's got the lighter and everything. He's going to light the gunpowder and he's going to blow. This is this silence, man.
Oh, man, I blew my fucking brains out right there.
Oh, I drink the water now, dude.
Jesus Christ. Drink the fucking water. Fuck you.
Gotta eat fast.
I convinced one of my exes once that that would feel really, really
silence.
Good. It would make her really high.
Oh, no. The silence is an offering to the dead air spirit.
You can't just sit there and be Schmeckle and have everybody do stuff for you.
They were all silent while I was blowing my brains out.
Well, it was a moment of silence. He's committing suicide, dude.
You bought Turtle Beaches too, Schmeckle.
Well, I was busy typing a very thoughtful question about firearms into the chat because I'm having an intelligent conversation about guns.
No, you're not.
There's no such thing as an intelligent conversation about guns.
Well, there is when there's people that actually know what they're talking about.
The only intelligent conversation about guns is how we should ban them, guys.
He's trying to be funny.
Trying to be.
So how you doing, Trippy?
Well, if we can get guns, we got problems.
Mm-hmm. Not too bad, Schmeckle. How you going? You getting along, man?
Up worry until about a you. Couple of minutes where I started smoking, joking on my smoke. I was doing great.
Right. Don't worry about you, buddy.
You guys hear about that girl?
Jerry killed juice to work until next week, you know? Just worried about you all the time.
I found some more conditioners. Now my hair is not, like, out to here like it was the stream.
It looks pretty good. Yeah, you look good.
Buddy Eddie wants me to ask you to show him your scalp.
Tell him it'll have to wait for another night.
So, Trippy, you southeast bound? You're local to the southeast of the United States?
Like I know that. Asking me a question about where I live.
I don't know where you are in the country.
It's a regional question. I'm
he's
not
trying
asking.
To ask my, or he's trying to... guess my origins.
Trying to get you docs. Now look.
No, it's totally fine. My name's out there and shit.
Okay, well, look, what I'm trying to get at is there's this girl on Snapchat the other day, and this made it onto the local news where
she
I'm at.
Just like me, right?
She committed it was a felony when she posted a picture of her cousin wearing a mask and holding a BB gun saying, don't come to school tomorrow.
Oh my God. Nah, I'm from Michigan, man.
Ah, Michigan. Home of the Redskins.
Yeah, why not? Well, we got the Red Leaf team.
Look, I'm going to be honest. If it's fucking farther north than the Mississippi, you know what I mean, and the Mason-Dixon line down there, fuck that place. Fuck it. I'm never going there, and it's never happening. Dongwave, you can buy all the property you want. You can put up a fucking amusement park. I'm not going there. Ever.
Where's that?
Anywhere that's not Florida.
Oh.
Brock, okay. Why are you on mute? I'm not here to yell at you for blocking me. I thought it was funny. Block me back. I was calling you block us and everything. It was great.
Sorry, I was eating.
You broke it. Well, I hope you're eating good food.
Eating what are you guys drinking tonight?
Cheap beer.
Cheap beer.
Not a damn thing.
Dongwave.
Water. I'm out of bourbon.
Oh, man. I am drinking really cheap pre-mixed frozen drinks.
I put too much barbecue sauce in
That's terrible.
Yeah, it is, but they've been in my freezer for a year. 2 years.
Just straw up, Ruckus. Just,
why
just
did they
throw there.
Up there?
Oh, it's just fucking
you know, just alcohol in the house. You try to keep a variety.
You had a girlfriend 2 years ago when she bought them, or?
I've got a wife. I've had a wife for a year and a girlfriend before that for 10 years. Something like that, 11, 12 years. Okay, so I guess it's explainable, huh?
Yeah, I would say it's explainable if a lady bought it for you.
No, I bought it myself. I keep a variety of alcohol around the house.
It's not good.
You got hard liquor, and then you got something, you know, that you just throw into a cup and throw more hard liquor in.
If I don't want hard liquor, I drink beer.
Yeah, the only beer worth drinking is Yang Ling, and other than that, it's all garbage.
Yeah, it is all garbage, but I'll still drink it. It's cheap, and it gets me drunk.
Yeah, but it's absolutely jam-packed full of calories, my dude. You can't be doing that to yourself. Unless it's good, strong, dark beer, it's probably not even... It's not worth it. Dark beer is good for you.
Motherfucker, right. I thought I was pushing 180. It turns out I'm, like, barely pushing 160.
Yeah, but you look like you're pushing the grain.
I'm going to bring it back onto topic. So
I am
actually messaged by Scooby. Is there, like, this list of people again?
Yeah, it was apparently AP, Irate. I think he mentioned you in the list. Mm-hmm. Adamantine. It was a good amount. Weibo, I think.
I got a direct direct message, and I was like, what the fuck? I haven't talked to this little shit heel since September. And he messaged me in November, and he's like, I'm going to report you guys for the Internet Crimes Division of the FBI. And I was like, good luck. And I hit enter, and I'm like, oh, he blocked me.
Yeah. Okay. And
So I had to ask his girlfriend, Tara, to get some more clarification on that.
We've all been really mean to Scooby.
Hey, it wouldn't be considered mean, I don't think. It's like you're bullying somebody who's trying to be a bully.
Oh, yeah. I think it's...
So it's only fair game.
It's a fair type of mean. But, I mean, I'm going to be, like, a lot more mean to Scooby than I've ever been in the next couple days.
I already went off on him on some other stream.
No, I'm working on a track about him. And it's
oh, don't
really,
do that.
Really,
really, you really want to put people who are going to click that link through that again? No, don't be making tracks, man.
Man, everybody seems to like it.
Well, you know, if people like it.
I mean, this one's a little different from the last one, the Maddox one I put out.
Mm-hmm.
But it's mean. Is very mean.
Oh, come on. You guys are all puppy dogs compared to me.
No, yes. I'm sure you're much more cruel than we are.
A straight face and listen to this stupid-ass story.
I as Schmeckle, am known as being a particularly gentle person.
Absolutely.
It's like my main thing. Like I'm a teddy bear.
Yeah. I mean, like, look, the reason that Scooby wears the hockey mask is because when he takes it off, people think he's wearing a hockey mask.
That strangely made way too much sense.
I know, right?
I've seen what's off. Under the mask, and it's not far from the truth.
He's got that missing tooth. That fucking...
He's not what you call an attractive man. He might be a BBW if he had a pussy.
Maybe. I mean, the man looks like he belongs in a refrigerator box.
He can still be a BBM, man. Big, beautiful man. Think about it.
No, because the middle part there is beautiful. He's just a big man. Not like a big man, but like a big man.
Oh, you remember when he showed us the pictures and he was like, that was back when I was a weightlifter. Yeah. It's like, you knew when you were in... weight training when you were in high school? Is that what that's from?
No, that's what it looked like. This is when I was 15 and I had lifted weights for a couple days.
He's been attaching weights to his balls ever since. He's a weightlifter, dude, every day.
Oh, I doubt that. I mean, that might actually give him big balls.
No, that just stretches the skin.
Yeah, it just makes them hang down further. It don't
or at least a big sack. Thing. Yeah. But yeah, he messaged me that shit. I had to ask Tara for more clarification, and then he tells me he's going to report us all to the FBI. And then today, I fucked with him a little bit in her Discord. And he says that he's going to contact the IRS because that's what his congressman told him to do. And that the IRS will help the FBI fast track the paperwork. I don't think that's how it works.
That makes a lot of sense. That makes a lot of sense. The IRS works for the FBI to fast track paperwork based on non-financial crimes. It's a step-by-step process. I think you all can walk with me.
Well, yeah, I mean, if you're really worried about revenue, as the IRS is, the Internal Revenue Service, then sometimes you got to stop cyberbullying. Because that's an important part of revenue.
Right. Well, the whole thing is that he's trying to report us all for tax evasion and tax fraud. And everything is taxes. And I'm like, don't think that people pay taxes off of the money that they receive if it's high enough amount?
Motherfucker, if I am tax evading, it's on my fucking accountant.
Is the U.S. IRS going to go after Speckle in Canada?
You have to go.
Also, yeah, the IRS ain't here.
You have to go out of your fucking way to avoid taxes, man. You have to really be like, you know what?
Oh, yeah.
Main source of income, fuck that, I'm not reporting.
Well, no, I mean, this ain't my main sense of income, but I do get some money from it, right?
Look what they did to Blake, and man.
I report that money because I make that money.
To start with, the IRS, under $500, there's no way they're even going to pursue it. It's going to cost them way more.
It's a very simple form you can print off from fucking either AdSense or Patreon or whichever.
Like, what is it? Is it a 1099B or something? What is that?
I have no idea which form.
Schmeckle knows these things because at one point he was monetized.
Yeah, exactly.
You can't laugh at yourself, you know.
No, when I was monetized, I had to fucking pay attention to that shit, right? Even with the Streamlabs we get now, I have to pay attention to that shit, right?
Exactly, because if you make over a set amount, you have to report that shit, or else
I'm pretty sure in Canada it's like more than $400 a month, which we easily do. So I need to report that shit.
Absolutely.
Man. You know, you gotta think about all the people on sell stuff on Craigslist and how much money they make and how much money they don't report making to the IRS.
Right.
To be fair, I can see you getting away with that.
Well, no, it's...
As much as you should report your shit to the government and all that, if you're doing a quick private sale, I don't see any issue with not reporting.
I do.
With shit that's easily traceable, like any donation I get through any source is, you've got to fucking report that shit. If somebody hands you cash for something you're selling, I don't give a fuck if you don't report that.
You guys remember just a little while ago all the Instagram whores who were getting lit up?
Yeah.
No, that was fine work. That was fine.
The thought audit.
Yeah, the thought it.
The thought it.
I don't really think that was
No, that was.
I think obviously that those chicks
don't be doing bumps of coke on live stream. What are you doing? I saw it.
I rubbed my nose. You never saw me sniff nothing.
No, it's always.
I heard it. I seen it.
Into something like that, but at the end of the day, you know, it was definitely a shit show, and I enjoy a good shit.
You know, no, I think those chicks should be paying taxes and shit. I also think it was definitely a bunch of bitter dudes who went along with the reporting and shit.
On top of that, I think quite a few of them were paying taxes.
A lot of them were, and that's one of the main issues with it. Is a lot of what these bitter guys were doing was. Hitting people with unnecessary audits, which take up a very large amount of time. They bother your they interfere with your life significantly. It was the ones that weren't paying taxes, I can kind of see it. It was still people going after them because they were bitter. But yeah, these people should be paying taxes.
Man, no, that completely.
They went after any fucking chick that was in sex work. And a lot of them, like Trippy said, were paying taxes. So it was just an unnecessary fucking audit.
If I made 10K in 1 year on sex work, I'd be thinking about the fucking taxes. I would not be thinking, oh, you know, I'm just going to let this be.
Oh, no, and the ones that didn't pay taxes were being fucking dumb.
If I made all that money off of playing with my vagina, I'd be worried that my vagina wasn't going to work properly in the future.
That would also be a worry.
They were.
I hear the house of Mouse's tractor trailers rolling into town.
Wait. Is the house of Mouse going to show up? Scooby, Tara, Scooby, Tara, you guys coming? We invited you. At the start of the night, I was all prepared to be peaceful fucking schmeckle.
Who's this guy?
I'm ready.
Oh.
This is our local faggot. He takes a bunch of notes on shit, so.
For a minute, I thought he was on their side.
Well, he used the notes on shit.
No, this guy takes notes on everything. If I need to remember something, I reach to him.
Yeah, I guess.
Linus, I told you you'd be part of the family. That's your job in the family.
Okay.
That's his lineup.
What do I need to? What?
Richie.
God, let me get the notebook out. God damn it. Okay.
See, I told you he's got a goddamn notebook. He says
he's trying to watch
everything.
The notebook. What are you talking about?
I just have a notebook. Whenever he wants me to do shit, I pull a notebook out to mark down whatever the hell he wants me to mark down. Hold on.
I have a secretary. You know how I always talked about getting a secretary? I have a secretary.
Jesus Christ, yeah. I am the secretary.
Yeah, he did. But Schmeckle, every time I see you, you're looking more and more like Santa Claus. Is the transformation for this year begun?
I keep forgetting to shave the beard.
Oh shit!
I really should. Like, I'm seeing what it looks like right now. It's buffing out way too much of the sun.
Okay, so one thing I noticed you guys were doing throughout the entire stream was you were talking about the Amazon wish list, the fact that he's
he had the world's largest dildo on there.
Do you guys not remember there were actually two Disney dumbasses that you guys were dealing with, the Mickey and Scooby. Scooby had the Mickey Mouse head, and Mickey was the crippled ginger with the missing tooth.
Yeah, it was so fucking weird.
Yeah, yeah. So,
it's okay, though. It's okay. We have proof that it goes to show, okay? The FBI and the IRS are more concerned with working with a Nazi mouse than they are a Riddlebox clown or an ape or an ogre thing. Except for we never tried to reach out to the FBI or the IRS.
I actually reach out to the FBI every day, every time any of you say anything mean about me.
Oh, okay. It seems to be what Scooby does.
Brockus the other day just complained about me being mean to him, and I reported him to the FBI.
Oh, okay.
It's kind of my thing now.
My dude, you've been bullying me.
A motherfucker, yeah. I'm calling the FBI right now.
All right, well, while you're doing that, my dude, you've been bullying me.
It's the Furry Bureau of Incest. The Furry Bureau. You gotta watch out for those guys. Look, he did another bump of coke. Oh, never mind, that's Ajax. At least you're keeping your nose clean.
Nah, it's just regular bleach. I've been dealing with all this Scooby shit. Sometimes you need to snort
something. That's what Ajax is. It's powdered bleach.
Oh. Then good, we're on the same page.
Whichever one.
You guys brought up the Amazon wish list and shit, so I decided to dig and see where what Scooby's account on Amazon is doing right now. He changed the profile picture to a picture of a Buddha.
No, it was like that when we looked at it.
Oh, I thought his was the one with the alternative Mickey Mouse that wasn't Nazi.
No, it was Buddha when we looked at it.
Oh, well, okay, never mind then.
But yeah, he had stuff on there. He had a bunch of fursuits.
Of course.
Which, as regular people will have.
Dude, I've got a couple of GIMP suits on my Amazon wish list right now, me bro.
He had the world's largest dildo immediately after a bottle or immediately before a bottle of lube.
Wait, what good is the world's largest dildo? I may need to ask
him for some recommendations on that.
What good is the world's largest dildo? I assume with the bottle of lube he got afterwards, it was like a gallon jug of lube or something.
It's for the world's largest. The world's largest dildo is for
the world's most distended anus.
I was going to say it's probably for an interesting way to commit suicide.
Or that, you lube up, you jump down, and you're done.
Yeah, like drop off of a second story building.
Dude, there was a guy who fucking did that. He dropped off of a high rise and landed on a parking median pole, and it just went all the way up his anus.
Well, that sounds
so bad.
I mean, either way, you're probably dead pretty quick, but I feel like that's a much more embarrassing.
Oh, no. The best part about it is they kept respirating him to keep him alive so the organs would stay.
No, at that point, don't keep him alive.
No, they did it for the organ.
You don't want to live after that. Oh, he was an organ donor, so they just get pumped.
Aw, did Scooby get rid of his Amazon wish list?
Yeah, don't become an organ donor. They'll keep pumping you after you have a fucking giant anus room and parking pole shoved up your ass.
But one of the interesting things on Scooby's wish list was a book called Sicilian for Beginners.
Yes, oh, okay. It was the book on Sicilian grammar.
Yes. He was... he recently called AP a fake paisan.
Did AP even ever claim that he was a real paisan? I know that he mentioned he was half, but...
Yeah, he's half Italian and he lives in Texas.
Yeah, so he's not trying to... Okay.
So if you guys want the exact wording, I had messaged on Discord to Scooby, because I get the screenshots. I asked him, if he was still... Are planning on reporting me for tax evasion. He says, yes, actually, I'm planning on, and I think somebody wrote this for him, I'm planning on submitting paperwork with the IRS as well as filing with my congressman to contact the agency on my behalf and to coordinate through a liaison. It's the exact same thing I did to all of you back in September with the FBI. It was actually the FBI that had asked me to file, as once the IRS gets involved, it greatly expedites the subpoena process. They're trying to get warrants for your various Discord servers. I'm like, they need a warrant to click a link.
All right, so Scooby, since I know you're probably either watching right now or gonna see this in the future, my name is Tommy Schlesinger. I am a Jewish Canadian.
His real name is
the hair and nose to match it. I would like you to direct the IRS, the FBI, toward me because of the thing that I'm going to say immediately following this sentence.
Fondle my insides.
I have had sex with your mother. It was not good sex. I was left disappointed afterwards. I felt like her vagina was a little bit too sloppy. It had been maybe a little bit too long since she had had sex. Like maybe she'd been waiting since your daddy left her.
Oh, damn it.
I felt like despite the fact that I have a relatively large cock, it did not fit inside the loose cave that is your mother's pussy. I felt like rather than spelunking, I was skydiving. You know, I had that feeling of free falling while I was on top of her. At the same time, I still do think your mother is a beautiful woman. I did pump another child into her. I mean, I had to fake my orgasm while having sex with her, but after she passed out drunk, I did squirt my sperm into her vagina, which was just sitting there gaping open, ready for sperm to go into it. It was like a bowl. It was like I was squirting into the garbage can at that point.
Schmeckle, don't you only fuck canonically 80-year-old fat women?
That's how Scooby got
here. No, no, no. 30 years younger, 80 plus. His mother, you got to remember, he's 40. She's only in her 70s, but she looks 80 because of the stress of having to deal with a son that turned out like that.
So it works for you. Is what I'm
Yeah, as long as she looks 80, it works for me.
Man.
Who's running OBS for you? Is it Dongwave?
Yes.
Hey, it's Dongwave, yeah.
You know you don't have to present your mouse. It's really fucking annoying.
Oh, well, you know, I have another Chrome window open, and I'm looking at guns, so deal with it.
Yeah, your mouse keeps dancing around. It's fucking annoying.
But anyway, the last thing I would like to say to you, Scooby.
Try to be a little professional.
I'll be your new daddy by next year.
I'm going to stand up for Dongwave right now, and you can go ahead and take my...
Oh, you can sit right back down, dude.
You can take my dick right near
me. If you're addressing me, you should raise your hand first.
Hey, look, dude. You got tonsils? Because you're about to choke.
Yeah, on what? Your pinky? Because that's way longer than your dick.
I love this. I wasn't even aiming for a fight, and we got a fight. Hold on. You guys...
I know, he thinks he can fight, but he's going to break down real quick.
Here for all about... Oh, 5 minutes, and I'm wondering to myself.
I was on the show long before you.
How much testosterone has the doctor prescribed you? Because you've obviously got a deficit that is.
This guy's trying to use words he can't figure out how to get out of his mouth, guys.
Oh man, yeah, I'm so sorry. Those words.
Maybe you should clear out the cum first, and then.
Sprockus, you shut your goddamn mouth and let this happen.
I'm not afraid of who I am, dude. Are you afraid of?
I'm not afraid of who you am either.
Who you am?
I'm not afraid of who you am either.
All right. Well, tell you what.
You got something to say, I'll let you say it.
1488 Burton Street in Independence, Missouri, and we'll do this.
What, are you trying to pull a Tonka on me?
Oh.
You got a lot of people around you, Schnipple, that want to pretend that they can fight in real life because they can't handle themselves on the internet.
Yeah, no, I'm sorry. The 1488 thing. I don't like Trippy.
1438.
Oh, 14. Oh, yeah, it was an actual address. I thought you said 1488.
I don't know. It's a quote from Rick.
It's
not
going to be his actual address.
Oh, it's
I don't think that dude would be that retarded.
If you think I got an actual problem with you over the last five.
Yeah, I know, dude. I don't even know you.
Now, see, to address something actually relevant, I agree with the statements about people who pretend to fight. That's why I've never said I'm going to fight anyone. I'll just shoot you. I've always been very consistent.
I will fight anybody.
Stop presenting your mouse. It's ridiculous.
Look at it. Look at it. It's bothering you, isn't it? Look at the mouse.
Increase the size of your mouse.
Look at it dance around.
You can go around on your Google Chrome thing, and you can do whatever you want, and people don't have to see your mouse moving around. Are you that dumb?
Dude, you got poop.
I know this, and I've only been using... Do I? Oh, do I? Or is my channel name Trippy Cast? You don't know shit, do you? I heard you've already torched several streams, so have a lot of good luck on this one. I
torched streams.
One day you know how to use stuff.
Oh,
one day he'll learn how to use OBS correctly, Schmeckel. But by that time, he'll probably already have said you
back. It's actually my software that can't use OBS.
Mm-hmm.
But I've
only got 8 gigs of RAM, and I'm doing it.
Juggalo, Trippy.
Actually,
before your mama's legs could spread.
First off, I said software, I meant hardware. But it might be the internet. Something makes it so that I can't run OBS.
You know, I do know how to remove the mouse, but I'm going to leave it on because it bothers you.
But no,
I'm just saying that to try to help improve your layout there, buddy. If you want to be a little dick about it.
Which one do you have an issue with? Frasier or Dongwei?
I'm going to have an issue with whoever.
Which one were you just talking about? With one day they'll fuck you over? Because it's Dongwei for
real. Oh, that's Dongwei. That's definite. He'll either fuck you over or he'll just completely trash your stream.
I mean, I don't want to take Trippy's side, but the other day, Dongwave did make us live on Talker's channel instead.
Hey, if anything, that helped funny, that though. Stream. We got
that's
more viewers that
funny.
Time.
That's true.
We did. We did get more viewers after popping up for a couple minutes on Talker's
channel. Dude, I don't even know Dongwave. Oh, if he can't handle it, that's one thing. I think he can handle it. If he's on here, he could probably take a little shit talk.
Yeah,
actually, he usually sits in the background and says nothing because that's what we
I get it.
I have yet to hear shit talk on the internet that's rivals the banter that my friends and fraternity brothers have given me. It's
oh my
it's
god, he's a frat boy.
Oh, of course he's a frat boy. Have you heard the gun clicking?
I graduated. I'm not currently living.
Just go back to your frat until you've hit an age where you don't want to spike your hair up any longer, okay? Or where you'd like to wear a shirt while drinking with your boyfriends.
I've seen him. He does not wear a shirt, but he does not spike his hair.
I had no clue that I could be more aroused by Dong Wave than I did now.
Oh, well, that's goddamn frat boy. That's okay. You can go.
Oh, wait, I almost forgot. I'm walking away for a moment. Trippy's in charge.
Of course I am. I was in charge of all your streams when I was on them regardless.
Trippy, what up?
What up, Enoid? I haven't talked to
What's
you in a while.
What's going on,
man.
My brother? Yeah, I know, man. I've been fucking busier than a one-legged man in an ass-kicking contest.
Ah, shit. And I just see that resulting in you hopping around in a circle.
Yeah. It tends to be how it works.
He walked out of IHOP and he forgot his leg. Oh, shit.
Well, I seen he was on. I wanted to come on and just say what up to you, man. I've been in the middle of the you're having like a fucking a cunt stream reunion and shit because of fucking Scooby.
Yeah. I mean, hell, it kind of deserves it. Trippy. I got all these new piles of shit that are on this channel, though.
I love you, Trippy.
Yeah, okay. I have a better soundboard than that, and I lack a soundboard.
That's not a soundboard, jackass. That's a real gun.
Well, good for you. I'm glad that you borrowed your daddy's gun.
Yeah.
Too bad you're not old enough to have bullets yet.
Yeah. Oh, man. Anyway, I heard about that shit with you and Ace. You know what I'm saying? I was, you know what I mean?
It's not really me and Ace. It's just, and it was a little bit of an issue with one of the streams, but. I mean, I'm sure Ace will come back. It's all good. Whatever.
You know, I got a lot of love for Ace, man. He's a good dude.
Same.
You know what I mean?
He's a good dude. Yeah. It's just, you know, difference of opinions, difference of things like that. It comes and goes.
Yeah. You know what I mean? Fucking, you know what I mean? I figured I'd just hop on, say what up to you real quick. I get back to work and shit. You know what I mean? But it's been a minute since I want to tell you, I ain't avoiding you. I'm just busy. Yeah, dude.
Same here. I wouldn't avoid Pinoid. That's that dude. Yeah. He used to go around and tell everybody that they should sub to me. Oh my god!
Hell yeah! All the time.
See, I said,
come by some Thursday, man. Fuck, we still do our Thursday streams and shit. Come by, we'll fucking pop you on, even get you some more.
Depends on what time. Yo,
just hit Thursday. Today.
All right. Well, are you in like the afternoon or night? This is a weird place to do this. Okay. Yeah, I started like 11. So.
Yeah, I started like 9:30, and I run to like 11. So like, if you'll have time, you know what I mean? Hop on, hop off. I can send some people over your way when I'm done. You know what I mean?
All right. Cool.
You know, holla at me, man.
You still doing the Church of Jesus Christ is not a bitch made nigga.
Man, look, I didn't have a chance to do it this week, and I'll be honest with you, my laptop, it's been acting like a piece of shit and not letting me do shit. I don't know what the deal is.
Yeah, it happens. Hell, I had to switch to fucking Discord to run OBS.
Yeah. Like, I run OBS, and, like, it just straight don't work. And I don't like doing it on a fucking Hangout, because once you have OBS and you're running OBS, you're like, I don't want to go back to a fucking Hangout. You know what I mean?
Right. No, Hangouts has been acting like shit lately anyways. This is it's good. Networking live. it's done. Except for, while we got to, like, talk shit about somebody during the banter.
I got some leak banner for you, man. Is that a prolapse on your nose? I mean, what is that? Is that a rose? But what's going on here?
You got a what banter? Did you say
no, leaf man, banter? It's leaf banter. 13-37 banter.
Let's see. When you say leaf banter, I gotta ask you: are you talking about Andy or are you talking about leaf?
No, I said leap, my dude. Leap. Oh, but don't worry about it. It's okay. I understand you got hearing problems, all the dick in your ears. Now look.
Okay.
The prolapse nose.
It's too bad. If I had any relation to you, I'd be scared I had dicks in my ears. But real good almost joke there.
You got some genetics in common.
One of these days, dude, you'll actually say something that's funny and entertaining.
Is that supposed to mean that you've been saying things that are funny and entertaining?
Oh, yeah. How many subs do you have?
I don't know.
It's about subs now.
I'm going to go the average route.
Going
the average route. Shut up. Try to build a rapport and act like this guy hates me for real. What the fuck is wrong with you? You're poking holes in our non-logic. This is the no longer cunt stream. Okay? Doesn't work like it used to. Does it? Is this still the same shit, Schmeckle, that you were doing like months ago? I mean, like, is it basically the same thing?
Yeah, basically.
Okay. Okay. So
same rules.
Musical literacy? Yeah, still going.
Well, no, not same shows. Same rules.
Yeah, I saw that you were getting like, you know, 5 viewers when you were doing the show that I was on. Was it what was the name of that show? Fringe Yesteryear. I saw you were getting like 5, maybe 15 viewers.
It's hitting more than it used to.
Well, that's good. Less than it was when I left, though.
No.
Right before I left. You guys were at like 30 viewers a night. And then you had a severe drop off. I wonder why. Because it could be because I was dropped under false pretenses and you still haven't watched that stream.
No, the drop off didn't
drop off happened right after I left because you decided to kick everybody that had any kind of entertainment value.
We had barely any viewers for the show. We had one good show with you.
Yeah, you can't look at the numbers anymore, guys, because it's well, all your shit got deleted. I'm not happy what happened to your channel.
I actually gave a nice little representation on Twitter, though.
Yeah.
That's still
available. Well, I mean, you had people coming on that were...
We had the one big show with you. Then we lost some after the channel got hacked. Now it's doing better than it did.
But you
want to
say one. But, make the difference.
Well, it was one.
Nah.
It was the
show with you. We had the show with the dude. Wait, are you talking specifically about a certain
We had multiple with Cameron. I'm talking Cringy Yesteryear.
I'm asking. Hey. Yeah, that's what I was asking.
Cringy Yesteryear. It was only the last Yesteryear show
with the guy from
a good amount of views.
Yeah, the. I was thinking of the Blackman button. Either way, you had multiple.
Yeah, that Blackman button's a different one. That was me and random co-hosts every week.
Everything except for the fucking Michael Jackson one, which that wasn't anybody's fault. The plan was something completely different. I think it was Maddox, and then you had a vacation that you had to go to.
Maddox.
Yeah. But no, the only one that got any good views for Cringy Yesteryear was the...
Can you remember?
The only Cringy Yesteryear episode that had good views with you. Was the last one you were on.
Yeah, that's a bunch of bullshit.
That's
you want to make it look like it's one thing.
If you want to go through the conversation, you brought up how it had like 200-something views. And I pointed out, first off, that 200-something ain't great. And second, the ones
it was doing
that
better
like
than 3 out of 4 of the shows on your channel.
80-something. 90 something.
You just want to hide behind that schmeckleness right now, eh?
No, that's why those shows got canceled as well.
Nah, you kept doing it after I was gone, and it dropped off on viewers greatly.
I
know what happened, dude.
You can look at the current numbers and the numbers that you claimed were big.
For your channel at the time, for a channel with 2,000 subscribers, having 20 viewers at a time was big for you during that little thing.
Yeah, you were pointing out that was big, and what I'm pointing out is that now with
you,
the smaller channel, that show
I get more
views
on my channel that has a fraction of the subscribers that channel had. I was pulling more views when I was part of your show than your show was pulling.
You
don't act like you got a big cock when you don't, Schmevel.
I could see the numbers that were around while you were doing that. You were
Your definitely changes when you have anybody to fucking challenge you.
Trippy,
am I addressing you?
Hold on, Trippy, Trippy, shut up. How long have you wanted to be Jim? How long have you wanted to be Mr. Medicare?
If he was asking me.
I don't have to be Mr. Medicare. I can be Trippy Poop, Trippy Cast. I could be fucking Schmeckle's daddy right now.
How long have you wanted to be Mr. Medicare?
How long have
the rest of us? I don't
know
about the rest. It's obvious to me that's what you want. You're a little wannabe Jim.
Kiss my dick, Dong Wang.
And I'm going to be honest, Dong. I don't see that.
You don't see it?
You can't see it the way he acts, man. It's textbook.
I'm asking him questions I haven't gotten.
Not really, no. He's asking me questions about a beef that we have. I don't see
him
acting like Madagascar.
Me and you were never even on, we were never not speaking.
Well, no, I'm never on.
You know, like, we weren't sitting there fucking talking shit to each other. It might have been about each other, but who the fuck gives a shit about that? That's fucking internet drama bullshit.
Yeah, the Metacritic genre of video usually... the only other two, I think, who actually do it are Toad McKinley and...
Are you sitting on your balls right now?
What?
I said, no, are you on your
trippy,
balls?
Trippy, trippy, trippy. He's gay.
Yeah, you trying to commit a hate crime over here, boy?
I don't give a shit. wow, but, you keep pulling that... just keep...
I got it in my hand. I got to either put it away or cock the gun.
But, yeah, the only other two... Queen of Paws and... what's his name? Oh, yeah, Toad McKinley. Yeah, those are the... What are you talking about? Who actually do Metacritic style bits. Trippy Poop, you're just a host.
I copy so Metacritic style a little bit in my videos. What few videos I have done.
Why is it going to be Metacritic style? Why can't it just be pointing out hypocritical bullshit?
Wow. No, that's
deep.
There's more to it than that. I mean, plenty of people have pointed out hypocritical bullshit. Without
but
having
a
that same sort of edge
mean that you're
to
trying
it.
To be like somebody else.
I didn't realize we were all Socrates up in this bitch.
Look, having your own opinions and doing your own thing
is illegal.
Why does it have to be listed as Metacritic style? Is he the only person that ever fucking did it? No. Is he the first one to do it? Fuck no.
He's going to be the last.
Is he going to be the last? Only if you guys turn into a bunch of pussies.
Dong Fraser both have fucking guns.
Yes.
Am I giving fucking clicks from both sides?
It's actually
you're
the
not
same
American.
Gun.
I don't expect you to understand, but we all have guns here.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah, it's the same gun. They just like cock
it. Stop clicking the fucking gun.
I put mine away.
Good. Dong, follow his example.
No. Dong, click it.
But I would, but
Dong,
hold on. The one that I usually go to for that kind of sound effect. "Quote unquote," putting it away is still within arm's reach of where I am now.
Wow.
Don't put it in the front of your pants. Turn the safety off, and we'll let nature go its course.
Also, do jumping jacks.
Trippy, how many
do some fucking?
How many streams have you been on? What's your stream doing? What stream are you on?
Explain to me who you are, because I've never even heard of you.
Oh, nobody's heard of me, dude.
No, Fraser's like all some right. Backup guy for Dong. I'll answer for Trippy. Trippy runs his own show. Plus, he used to be a host here.
Well, I just wanted to know. I was.
He's been
quite
he's,
some time, but not like
been around.
A year or nothing. I was a viewer of this for a long time. This because it was just a change of name. You guys are still being yourselves.
Con stream snatch,
which is good. I'm glad you guys were able to fucking. Come back and everything. Like people were fucking coming to me and asking me how the hell it happened. I'm like, I don't know.
Well,
I don't even think they know.
There are still people that have this suspicion since shortly after our beef with you, we got hacked. There are still people that think there's a connection, right?
Yeah,
personally,
good.
I don't. I've spoken and I've said out loud. I've spoken with the people that took the fucking account. They ain't you.
There you go. I mean, I'm shit. Even if I knew
there are people
that I wouldn't do it or even ask them to.
There's
no
there
point in that.
People that kind of tie the things together because of the timing, right?
Yeah, that was some fucked up timing. And I was waiting for the claims. I'm just like sitting back, like, yeah, wait, what? I wonder when somebody's going to say that shit. They might as well also say, oh, he's not a diabetic.
My first fucking thought was, this was Trippy or someone. And there were people telling me apparently Tama's husband is like a tech guy or something, and like a bunch of shit. And
ain't no way he did
like,
it.
No, they're this.
It was Tark.
It was easy to track where it came from, and it did not come from your country.
It's like it was targeted, but I don't think it was targeted at the people on the stream. I think they just wanted to... take somebody's shit and it happened to be you guys.
Yeah, and I actually at this point have the real names of the people that currently own it.
Okay.
They claim that they bought it.
Jesus.
Believe that. I think they were the guys that stole the account. But Either way, I can fuck them over, and I'm gonna have some fun with that.
There you go. As I know, they took over little Brocky Fufu here's channel too.
They did, and now that you mentioned,
they Brocky made it better. They got more subscribers than Brockus.
That's just mean, man. What do you think this is? The internet? Why are you being so mean? I mean,
Shiro and Koate says, "Don't try to be a Metacritic clone. Try to be the best you."
I am the best me. I wake up every morning and I look in the mirror and I say, "I love you, Schmeppel."
That's what I say when I look in the mirror.
Yeah, what, dude.
Brothers.
That's what I'm getting exactly.
How old is Scooby? Anybody got an estimate?
I think he's 39 or 40. No,
yeah, he's close to 40 or over 40. I don't know around that area.
Let's see. This was okay.
I can't believe that very recently there was actually a stream with Weebo Jones and I heard she fucking told him off today.
I heard AP wants to fuck her.
That's fine. But it was Scooby and fucking Poor Magog and Weebo, and they were all on the same fucking stream. And I'm like, why the hell is Scooby there?
Had the balls to go and face Magog and Weebo, but he doesn't have the balls to come and face Schmeckle.
Well, I don't
look
think
at my
were,
face. I am a gentle soul.
They weren't talking any kind of activities or anything. They were just having a shooty shit kind of stream, you know? They're having fun.
Oh, well, in that case, somebody please send Scooby a link just saying, "Hey, Scooby, Schmeckle would like to have a kind conversation with you about ice cream."
I can't even do it.
Ice cream is good, right? Like, do you like ice cream or gelato? Yeah, just invite him for that type of conversation.
And now I'm hearing there's going to be another fight that's supposed to take place the day that Andy and Tonka fight.
Between Tennessee Marine and Geek Thulu?
Actually, yeah, that's the rumor that I've been hearing.
Yeah.
I thought it was supposed to be Brockus and Geek Thulu.
Apparently, just fucking Geek Thulu woke up, pissed the hell off out of Tennessee Marine. And, well.
Dude, they could wear sumo suits, but all Brockus would have to do is his hair.
Brockus, I thought you were supposed to fight Geek Thulu. Why the fuck is it Tennessee Marine now?
Oh, no. That's relatively new, I guess. They were going down the list of people that can't stand Geek and hate his ass and want to fight him. So Andy actually proposed an idea, which Geek agreed to this morning, that it would be Andy and Geek versus me, Thrax, Broski, and Optic in a 2-against-4 handicap match.
Right. Andy is a lot smaller than Tonka. I am a lot smaller than Geek. I have been begging for one of these motherfuckers to fight me for longer than this fight has been a thing. One of these motherfuckers needs to face me in the ring and also pay for my flight and hotel.
No one's gonna do that, Schmeckle.
Well, then, Brockus, pay for my flight and hotel.
Sure, let me just pull the money out of my ass.
There we go! That was a verbal contract. He said sure.
Go fuck yourself.
He said sure. You all heard it.
Sounds like Brockus is too tired to deal with this.
I am. Like, I legitimately just fell asleep on the fucking stream. Didn't even realize it.
That explains
a lot. That's true. That is your job. But you pass out drunk. I passed out sick, apparently.
At least you didn't start throwing up on stream like Jimmy.
That would involve
the
drunk
one ending. Time we got drunk Samaj. The stream literally ended with
wow.
Motherfucker came on, yelled about a bunch of shit, and then puked.
Was that recent?
Past 3 months, 4 months, I think.
Oh, sure.
It was probably on the old channel, so it's probably not available.
Yeah, that was actually one of the last streams, one of the last 5 streams, I would say, we did on.
I mean, we're gonna be slowly uploading the streams. I'm thinking we're gonna put out the more important ones a little quicker. Like the Zefcock one, the Scooby ones, shit like that. And maybe I'll add Samaj puking everywhere to the list.
You could probably just edit that down to just that.
Yeah, we ended that stream with him saying, Schmeckle, end it, end it. And as I hit the button, I was like, okay, it's done. And he was like,
poor Samaj. He doesn't drink often. He drinks like, what, once every few years?
Yeah, this was, I don't think it's once every few years, but like very rarely, like maybe like 4 or 5 times a year, right?
Yeah.
And this time he drank a lot. Like he popped into the thing already drunk and kept drinking from there. And by the end, he was just puking his fucking guts out. Still yelling at shit, but also puking in between sentences.
Yeah, well, yeah, some people it just affects like that. I mean, yeah, I don't.
Well, what's this fucking beef between Trippy and Dong and Frazier? I mean, why are you guys fighting?
Yeah, because they're just little shits and they think they'll be popular
one day. When Trippy came here, I thought I'd be fighting with them.
I don't know Trippy. Yeah. I have no problem with him, but I will fight to the death against
him. Hey, you need to actually put a little effort into it.
No. Just like that image I made, I'm not putting any effort into anything.
Yeah, I see. You used your own uncircumcised penis for that, eh?
Yeah, sure did. It was hard to make a PNG
pretty so fast, but I did it. Skin. I mean, I guess that you got grow room.
Well, I don't know what I've been doing, man.
You got grow room. It's just too bad you're done growing.
Wait, hide your nasty-ass prolapse nose, so you're good to go.
Oh, you mean my swirl nose?
Prolapse.
My little swirl? What? Yeah. Are you upset that you're just... You lack any kind of creativity, artistic? The only thing anybody ever says about you is you're a great artist.
Jesus Christ. The old avatar was better, Trippy.
Aw, I know. It was so much better.
That's why everybody likes this one better. I can't be bothered to care that much. That's probably why I'm not invested in banter.
You can't see straight.
I generally don't get invested in it, and I just don't care. None of this is that important to me.
It's obvious.
I cared more about the conversation I was having about the others in the chat.
Look at your OBS layout, dude. It's obvious you don't care. It's fucking garbage. There's no creativity in that at all.
To be fair, Dongwave, I have sent you the other OBS layout. Should be.
Oh, that's good. You got a guy that runs OBS, but you have to have other people that make him stuff. Skills, but
Jimmy. Jimmy does all our shit. You know that.
Yeah, but I thought by this point you'd have Brockus run it over, yes.
Brockus used to, but then he sucked at it.
No, it's my computer can't handle it.
Oh, Trippy muted himself.
Oh, yeah, Brockus used the same goddamn excuse that I used.
Go fuck yourself. It's a valid goddamn argument, seeing as how every attempt I
If it's valid for me, it's probably valid for you, but still, don't steal my thing.
But... I legitimately tried on 3 separate occasions to actually run OBS for one of our streams,
reset
and I was failed
I
miserably.
Wait, but you only tried that on the Cunt Stream channel. What if it works better on the Snatch Cash channel?
And I could give you some pointers. I got a shit computer, and it works on
mine. Yeah, Trippy will give you some. Oh, God damn it! Now we're teaming up with Trippy.
Hey. It's really no problem.
Remind me to make an arc in our comic thing where we team up with an enemy.
I'm just taking a guess, my dude. Hey, the juggler thing, I'm thinking your tips involve putting cheetah stripes on the sides of your computer. And that's how you make it go faster.
No, you gotta have flame decals. Gives it more horsepower.
Oh, man, I was waiting for you to say that. See? You outed yourself.
Bullet holes that make him go faster.
You got truck nuts on your computer?
You need a spoiler to add downforce.
I mean, also, Brockus, I recommend running Windows XP. Gotta run that XP, man.
Neat.
Oh, I don't think I really want
to. Oh, I'm sorry. That must have been
like
before Frazier's birth. Is that what happened?
I'm sorry, Frazier's birth? Which Frazier? I'm the third Frazier, so you gotta be specific.
Yeah, you must have been born
You are Frazier the third? Are you fucking serious?
Yeah, dude. I'm serious.
Kill your father and then your grandfather.
You know what? It's better than they wanted to name.
Never name your kid something junior, but definitely never, ever name your kid something the third.
I don't know. I feel like Frazier gains a third kind of.
No, at that point, it's fucking ego. Your parents and your grandparents were bad parents and grandparents.
Like I said, I was going to be named John otherwise, so I'm happy. I'm good.
Like, God fucking damn it. If I was Thomas Schlesinger the third, I would have killed myself on my third birthday.
Why
three times.
Yeah, why wait that long?
No, I did just to make it line up with the threes.
See, you're into it. You're invested in the three now.
No, exactly. If I was the third, I would kill myself with all the threes in line.
Look, I'm just saying. I'm just putting it out there. But Trippy Poop, why don't you go ahead and addend your name to have a three at the end of it so you can commit suicide based on that exact line of logic.
Yeah,
not
all that retardism that just came out of your mouth, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
You're taking it too seriously, my dude.
Yeah, obviously, because you're a joke.
Well, clearly. I would never, ever say something serious about suicide and you in a room and a gun.
Okay. Look at that, he made himself laugh.
Yeah, I make myself laugh because I don't really give a shit. It's a big difference. Yeah,
that's why I brought him up.
The humor is. There's a very large lack of any kind of.
You're trying pretty hard to think that I'm not funny, but the thing is, it's like, hey, you know.
No, no, it was easy. You think everything's funny, don't you?
Like,
you probably sit there and watch an Amy Schumer movie in life, right?
I do. I watch Amy Schumer because it's like a tragedy.
He watches and masturbates.
Hey, you know what? Amy Schumer, as fat as she is, as fucked up as she is, I'd do her.
Yeah, this reminds you.
I'm already sick. Don't make me throw up.
Jesus fucking Christ!
You'd only do her because she reminds you of your mother. There's a little Oedipus going on there. That's all.
You didn't have to go there, man. You didn't have to. Oh no!
He didn't have to. But does Amy Schumer look like your mother, Frasier?
No, not even a little bit.
Anyway, on that note, Brockus. Shut this goddamn shit down.
I don't have control of it, you fucking retard.
I'm just saying, say the goddamn names of the people that do the Jimmy thing.
No way, keep it going. I want to talk to Trippy all night long.
Hey, you know what? If you want to keep it going, we can keep it going. I will allow. It seems hostile, so I'll let it keep going.
Oh, he left. He left.
I think that means you
win.
I was
so close to climaxing, too.
What happened?
Jesus fucking Christ.
Brockus, say the names of the people that were here. Do the shutdown thing.
God, that was
so hot. Make sure to point out that Scooby and his guys didn't show up.
Hey, just Trippy's working with Scooby, clearly. I mean, this is obvious to me.
Trippy and Scooby make love regularly, but they're not on good terms business-wise. It's just a sex thing.
Okay. Anyways... tonight we had, of course, myself and Schmeckle and the wonderful Dong Wave on the OBS running all the shit.
Thank you.
The nice little things that you get to see there.
Little more enthusiasm,
are those dancing
shoes?
They're on a Kurt made of matzo.
Just wanted to actually make sure that's what I was fucking looking at. Okay. Along with the three of us, we also have Frasier Danger, somebody I actually enjoy coming on the streets a lot. Lionel fucking Valentine. You gay ass weeb psychotic.
I'm the secretary now. He is. He's become the official secretary. I love that I found another employee that I don't need to pay.
I love this.
Can I at least get sexually harassed?
Yes,
I'll make sure that all of us sexually harass you.
Finally, Jesus Christ, I can.
As long as you do the secretary work, you'll get the sexual harassment.
We also had Irate Prostate very briefly. We had Tom Pinoid, Excel, Trippy Poop, and of course, one of the main guests for tonight, AP. Oh, yeah, and Leaf.
And Leaf.
She barely spoke. Well,
Piece of shit. Oh, we hate her. She's fired. Leaf's fired.
People barely heard her. She's not fired. You want her around because the vagina attracts.
That's true. She's fired if one of you can present a vagina that can replace her.
I have an asshole with
Lionel. Your mouth and or asshole does not count.
Yeah, your mouth and asshole are not vaginas, Linus.
Hey, they'll do in a pinch.
and they I will feel a pinch.
Frasier, you can do it in a pinch if you'd like. But we need a real pussy. Now, Christopher has said stream.shutdown true. Brockus, say the N words and then Dong Wave, you end.
Brockus, say the N word.
Nigga, I will fucking stab you.
Shut the goddamn stream down, away, Dong Wave.
Marty Robbins.
You came down to this southern town last summer to show the folks a brand new way of life. But all you've shown the folks around here is trouble, and you've only added misery to their strife. Your concern is not to help the people, and I'll say again, though it's been often said, your concern is just to bring discomfort, my friend, and your policy is just a little red. Now ain't I right?
Ain't you right? Ain't you right?
It matters not to you how people suffer, and should they, you consider that a gain. You bring a lot of trouble to the town and then you leave. That's part of your communistic game. I detect a little communism. I can see it in the things you do. Communism, socialism, call it what you like. There's very little difference in the two. Now ain't I right?
Ain't you right?
Your followers sometimes have been a bearded, bathless bunch. There's even been a minister or two. A priest, a nun, a rabbi, and an educated man have listened and been taken in by you. All the country's full of two-faced politicians who encourage you with words that go like this. Burn your draft card if you like, it's good to disagree. That's a get acquainted communistic kiss. Now ain't I right?
Ain't you right? Ain't you right?
One politician said it would be nice to send some blood and help the enemy in Vietnam. That's what he says, here's what I say, let's just keep the blood. Instead, let's send that politician mad. Let's rid the country of the politicians who coddle tramps that march out in our street, protesting those who want to fight for freedom, my friend. This kind of leader makes our country weak. Now ain't I right?
Ain't you right? Ain't you right?
Let's look and find the strong and able leaders. It's time we found just how our neighbors stand. If we're to win this war with communism, let's fight it here as well as Vietnam. Let's rise as one and meet our obligations, so communistic boots will never trod across the fields of freedom that were given to us with the blessing of our great almighty God. Across the fields of freedom that were given to us with the blessing of our great almighty God.